Shotgun, Michael Cole, along with Kevin Kelly. Incidents in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. You just saw a clip of it later on in the program, the whole story about Shawn Michaels, Bret Hart, and Vince McMahon. Plus, in action, Owen Hart and Mankind. The Headbangers will be here. What a show this week. Here's the Nation of Domination. Kama, Mustafa, and Farouk a bit depleted this week, Kevin, but I understand perhaps its most powerful member will be back Monday on Raw.
Well, Farouk will have the troops in full force this Monday. D'Lo Brown tending a Nation business this week, but Ahmed Johnson returns from a knee injury. He'll be there, ready to go, rehabbed and ripped, ready for a fight.
His opponent from the city of brotherly love, playing 43 pounds, Flash.
And there he is, Flash Funk. What a matchup this is going to be. Flash's high-flying, quick, acrobatic style against the power of Kama Mustafa.
It's a tall order indeed, I think, for Flash Funk, because he knows that Farouk will be on the outside of the ring. But neither Farouk nor Kama are going to have to worry about Los Boricuas or the DOA this week, Michael. They've been kind of put on hiatus for a little bit.
They have. President Gorilla Monsoon basically calling a cooling off period between the Los Boricuas and the DOA after the factional warfare we've seen over the past couple of weeks. I'll tell you what here, as Flash Funk gets ready to take on Kama Mustafa, it's going to be interesting to see what happens on Raw. Because the Nation, as we said, will be back in full force with Ahmed Johnson recovering from that knee injury. And Kevin, Ahmed all along has blamed the Disciples of the Apocalypse for injuring his knee so he would be out of the In Your House Canadian Stampede title match against The Undertaker.
I know Ahmed is going to return to Raw this week very determined, Michael.
Yeah, Ahmed Johnson will be back with the Nation of Domination. It's going to be unbelievable. This matchup should be unbelievable. Two wrestlers with contrasting styles. Flash Funk, of course, on your right in the red. He's agile, very quick, likes to fly off the ropes. And Kama Mustafa, the powerhouse of the two, very strong. He will use that strength in this matchup against Flash. Kama Mustafa now goes to work on Flash Funk as he backs him into the corner. What about this crowd here in Canada this week? They are wired and ready to go, Kevin.
They certainly are. Of course, they will see one of their favorite sons battle Mankind later on in the hour, folks. Owen Hart going after Mankind.
Look out. Whoa! Nice flying tackle by Flash Funk. Should have covered him there, though, Kevin.
Perhaps a mistake early in the match.
Oh, drop kick. Kama wobbly. Another drop kick. Kama through the ropes and outside the ring. Flash Funk taking control of this matchup. Let me ask you, Kevin, between the three factions we have, Boricuas, DOA, and of course the Nation, which team do you think is perhaps the most powerful? Uh-oh, look out though, let's hold that question as Flash goes up high. Double takedown, Kama and Farouk hit the mat outside the ring. Flash Funk in total control.
There's a nice how do you do for Flash Funk to the members of the Nation of Domination. Flash, wait a second, Flash, turn around,
Flash. Oh, man,
did you hear that? That was like a Johnny Tapia right hand. We got to take another look at Flash, who was high-flying and looking great on the double feature there, the double clothesline.
A 320-pounder now with big boots to the midsection. Another one knocking Flash Funk down to the middle of the ring. I'd asked you before, Kevin, out of the three factions, which group do you think is the strongest?
Well, I think the strongest group is the one who perhaps can attack from behind. All three groups have not been shy about making their intentions known about wanting to attack.
There's a cover. Two. Funk kicks out.
Each group has decided to try to inflict injury on the other. So I think the group that can strike first will be the strongest. All three are very well balanced.
Another kick by Kama Mustafa. Kevin, how does the World Wrestling Federation and the officials and the like handle this factional warfare when you've got so many men running around outside the ring? How does one referee handle that type of a match?
One referee does not handle that type of match. We've seen a lot of matches break down. We've seen a lot of men succumb to injury lately here in the World Wrestling Federation. And I think the World Wrestling Federation President Gorilla Monsoon needs to take a serious look at his officials as far as doing a better job of controlling things on the ringside. If we have to start putting armed police in each corner of the ring, if that's what it takes to keep the wrestlers safe, then that's what we need to do.
Big body slam. Flash Funk showing some power there. Here goes Flash up top. What's he going to do? Moonsaw. Got him. This could be it. Flash hooks the leg.
It's over.
We could have an upset. Oh, no. Farouk. Farouk grabbed the leg of Flash Funk, interfering in the match. Farouk now in the apron of the ring. Oh, Flash Funk caught him with the right hand, and Farouk paid for his interference.
Now, Kama drills Flash with a shot to the midsection, and Michael, we've seen this move before.
Oh, no. Here we go. Look at the power. This should be it. Kama should end this matchup right here as Flash Funk is in trouble. Here's the cover. Kama got him. Kama Mustafa, the nation, wins on shotgun.
An impressive effort by both athletes. Kama showing that power and might are the keys to victory. But having Farouk on the outside providing interference doesn't hurt either.
And don't forget, this Monday on Raw, the nation will be at full strength because Ahmed Johnson, the Pearl River powerhouse, will be back at Raw in Pittsburgh Monday night.
Farouk now lending a helping hand to Flash.
Oh, come on. Some helping hand. Unbelievable. Still to come on Shotgun, the deranged Mankind faces one of Canada's favorite sons, the Intercontinental Champion, Owen Hart.
Plus, I don't think another farm aid is going to cheer up these unhappy hog farmers. We'll hear from Phineas and Henry Godwin.
And we'll tell you why Bret Hart snapped on Vince McMahon. It had to do with the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, in an amazing announcement about SummerSlam.
And up next, we'll see those slam dancing, stage diving headbangers.
Son Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly, here they come, the headbangers. Mosh and Thrash are getting set for tag action. Listen to the crowd here in Canada. No matter where the headbangers go, whether it be Canada, anywhere in the United States, anywhere around the world, they have been accepted by the fans. This is a great tag team. They work well together. They might be a little unorthodox, but they are a great team. And this should be a good matchup tonight, a good test for the headbangers. Of course, the headbangers trying to work their way into contention now in the tag team situation in the World Wrestling Federation. They still have to get up on the level of some of the top teams like Owen Hart, the British Bulldog, perhaps the Legion of Doom, but they're not very far away. And if they keep it up, they should be there perhaps in the next couple of months. The headbangers, of course, were involved in that triple threat tag matchup this past week on Raw. The winners, the Godwins, they defeated the headbangers and the Blackjacks. And, of course, the Godwins get a shot for the championship this Monday in the war zone.
Yeah, victorious in that organized car wreck called a triple threat match. That was wild, to say the least. The Godwins victorious. We'll hear from them in a little while. Plus, I wonder what they're going to be thinking about when they face Stone Cold Steve Austin and Dude Love.
That's right. The first title defense for Austin and Dude Love. And you know what that means? If the Godwins can win that matchup, Kevin, they could go to SummerSlam. Oh, nice dropkick by Thrasher on Tony Roy. They could go to SummerSlam, the tag team champions, and put the belts on the line, possibly against LOD.
It would be a nice reunion with the tag team titles at SummerSlam for the LOD.
Oh! What a takedown by Mosh. Great double team by the headbangers. Tell you what, this crowd here in Canada really loves this tag team.
I enjoyed Thrasher's outfit, the lovely evening wear. Mosh, of course, something a little lighter for summer.
And speaking of dresses, Kevin, Ryan Pillman and Goldust set to meet at SummerSlam. Pillman says if he loses to Goldust, he will wrestle Goldust the next night on Raw in one of Marlena's dresses. Can you believe that? Pillman in a dress? It's going to be unbelievable. I don't know if I want to see Brian Pillman showing off his, I guess, hairy legs in one of Marlena's dresses. Mosh now working on Scott DeMore. Mosh is a great technical wrestler when he wants to be. And as you can see now, working on that right arm of DeMore as he backs Mosh into the corner. DeMore looking for the break, and he hits Mosh with a big right hand to the midsection. Another big forearm now to the side of Mosh's head. Backs Mosh, looked like he was going into the corner, but Mosh reversed it off the ropes. Here's a big back body drop. Mosh in control. Here we go now. Mosh with a big clothesline on Scott DeMore. The headbangers in total control in this matchup. They're really making a name for themselves here, the headbangers. Great teamwork. I mean, this may be the best pure team in the World Wrestling Federation.
A lot of people wonder why the headbangers are popular. I think it's for maneuvers just like this.
Oh, look at this. Thrasher in the small, the back of Scott DeMore. Double team again.
Fans love to see great tag team wrestling. This is what tag teaming is all about, using the five count to your advantage, using both men as combination against one. The fans appreciate that type of skill, despite the headbangers' unorthodox look. They've gotten a lot of attention from the fans.
Look at that double team. Thrasher tossing Mosh on top of Scott Demore. Even here in Canada, the fans love the headbangers. We talked about the factions a bit earlier, DOA, Los Pericos, and of course, the Nation of Domination. What we should mention is there is a new faction coming to Raw in Pittsburgh, that being the Truth Commission. What do we know about the Truth Commission?
Well, the Commandant will be leading Recon, Sniper, and the 7-foot Interrogator into battle.
7 feet?
7 feet tall.
Oh, Thrasher missed. Demore moving out of the way, and now the team of Roy and Demore hoping to gain some momentum here. Demore tags in Tony Roy to work now on Thrasher. There's the double team into the booth.
Now you see Roy and Demore. They're trying to put a little bit of tag team moves together, but you see they don't have the skill, the level of expertise that the headbangers do.
Here's Thrasher now with a headbutt, knocking Tony Roy down in the corner. The Truth Commission we have seen a couple of times here on Shotgun, and they have just rolled over their opponents, Kevin.
They are a very organized team. They have not been challenged yet, Michael. I'll be interested to see what they bring to the table.
Going to be interesting as Mosh now goes up on the top ropes. Thrasher lifting Roy high in the air. Look at this double team. Oh, my. Tony Roy, he needs another area code. He is out there.
These two young men are reckless. They're dangerous. And they're intense. They came within an eyelash of garnering the title shot.
Roy thinking Thrasher was his partner. He got tagged all right as Mosh hits him with an elbow across the back of the head.
They came within an eyelash of winning that triple threat match, and it could have been their title shot. Instead, ill-gotten means, the victory goes to the Godwins.
Thrasher now off the top rope across the back of Tony Roy. You will hear from the Godwins, Kevin, a bit later on in the broadcast.
It's been a bad week for Vince McMahon after what happened with Bret Hart and Shawn Michaels. We'll show you that whole situation later on. Now he's got to go and interview the Godwins, I see.
Unbelievable. The headbangers now working on Tony Roy. This is Mosh. Nice reversal by Roy. Oh, he telegraphed it, got the boot underneath the chin. Mosh now goes into the corner to tag his partner, Thrasher. I just think it's a matter of time before the headbangers are in contention for the WWF Tag Team Championship.
Oh, crazy!
Look at that music! Stage dive! The stage dive. This should be it. Thrasher covers Roy. It's all over. The headbangers victorious this week on Shotgun Challenge. What a matchup. What a win for the headbangers. Still to come on Shotgun Challenge, we'll see if the deranged Mankind can score a victory over Canada's own, the Intercontinental Champion, Owen Hart.
We'll see also if royalty can rule the ring. Jerry the King Lawler will join us.
And up next, what do Bret the Hitman Hart, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, and Vince McMahon have in common? We'll take a look back at what transpired. Stay with us. Welcome back to Shotgun. Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly, what a show we've had for you so far this week, and what a week it's been in the World Wrestling Federation. SummerSlam is just around the corner. So many things to get you caught up on. Let's take you back to Raw last week for a feel of what nationalistic, unbelievable, disturbing events in the World Wrestling Federation. And because of the actions against Shawn Michaels and also Vince McMahon, Bret will face a hearing in Pittsburgh before Raw this Monday. Now, apparently, Bret Hart and his attorneys will be in Pittsburgh to meet with WWF officials, including President Gorilla Monsoon. Kevin, any idea if sanctions will be issued?
Well, speculation abound, Michael, as to what exactly will transpire this Monday in Pittsburgh. But there are a few different scenarios that are taking shape. Number one, Bret could be heavily fined. Number two, Bret could be suspended from the World Wrestling Federation. And number three, Bret could also face termination.
Wow.
He could be fired from the World Wrestling Federation. But as it stands right now, it's still going to be Bret the Hitman Hart against The Undertaker for the WWF Championship at SummerSlam on August 3rd. Shawn Michaels will still be the special guest referee.
I'll tell you what, it's an unbelievable situation. I cannot wait until SummerSlam. Still to come this week on Shotgun, the Intercontinental Champion, Canada's own Owen Hart, in his own backyard, takes on the maniacal, the deranged Mankind. What a match.
And folks, up next, we'll see Jerry the King Lawler in action here on Shotgun.
Mein Name ist Bracket und ich komme von Deutschland. Mein Gewicht ist 300 Pfund. Und wenn ich nach Amerika zu der World Wrestling Federation komme und die Hart Foundation in den Ring kriege, werde ich sie zerbrechen.
Your weekend with us I'm Michael Cole along with Kevin Kelly. What a matchup we've got for you on Shotgun. Actually heading to ringside, he's going to be doing some commentary for the Shotgun Saturday night broadcast.
Boy, he'll have a hard time getting a word in edgewise with Jim Ross and Jim Cornette, that's for sure.
Can you imagine on this program? We wouldn't say anything.
That's true. We'd be strangely silent.
Look at him. Too sexy Brian Christopher, the alleged son of that man, Jerry the King Lawler. And here comes Scott Taylor, the 214-pounder from Maine, as I said, an exciting newcomer, one of the up-and-comers in the light heavyweight division.
Certainly is. He's a young man with a great future ahead of him. I had a chance to catch up with him not too long ago. He is a fine young gentleman, and I look for great things from this man in the light heavyweight division. He's competing out of his weight class here, giving up about 25 or 30 pounds to the King, plus about 20 years of experience to the crafty, KG veteran from Memphis, Tennessee, Jerry the King Lawler.
Scott Taylor telling me back in the locker room, the proudest day of his life is when he signed the WWF contract. He couldn't wait. That was the greatest day of his life.
And the biggest win of his career could be right here on Shotgun, a win over Jerry the King Lawler. But he's going to have to keep his eye out for Brian Christopher. Brian donning the headset for the Shotgun Saturday night broadcast, but just a couple of feet away from the ring.
Here we go now, Jerry the King Lawler getting upset with the fans here in Canada. Locks up now in the center of the ring against Scott Taylor, who backs Lawler into the corner, but Lawler reverses it now with a big left hand to the midsection of Scott Taylor. We are underway. This should be an entertaining matchup. Lawler ducks under, though. Here's Taylor. Look at this. Over top of Jerry the King Lawler. Scott Taylor now working on the King into the corner. Scott Taylor, nice slide underneath. He grabs the ankle now of the King. Great takedown. Taylor impressive.
Lawler looks like he's trying to catch a greased pig out there and not being too successful.
I'll tell you what, did you see that man? I guess he calls himself Baracus from
Baracus.
Germany.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
I mean, I don't understand too much of German, Michael. I picked up a couple of words here and there, but it's intense, that's for sure.
I mean, he is unbelievable. He is ripped, he's cut. I can't wait to see him here in the World Wrestling Federation. What about the situation coming up Monday? Bret Hart going into that hearing in Pittsburgh before Raw. The whole situation with Shawn Michaels and the disgrace, the embarrassing situation on Raw this past week. It was an embarrassment to see the way he treated Vince McMahon.
The entire McMahon family is truly embarrassed over what happened this past week. But you know, Michael, I think Vince McMahon feels very responsible for the legitimate heat that exists between Shawn Michaels and Bret Hart.
Oh,
what? I don't
Lawler
believe what I just
kick.
Saw.
It's unbelievable.
Shades of 1975. Lawler left the mat. I don't believe it.
Jerry the King Lawler with a great dropkick on Scott Taylor.
Michael, getting back to Shawn and Bret, these two men truly dislike one another. The personal, the professional jealousy has now transcended the ring once again. Vince McMahon was in the middle of it this week, and I think he feels responsible for the tension, for the hatred that exists between these two.
Scott Taylor now into the turnbuckle from Jerry the King Lawler. SummerSlam just a week away at the Continental Airlines Arena. I'll tell you what, the championship match, The Undertaker against Bret Hart.
It has been truly a very busy week here in the World Wrestling Federation. All of us are just out of breath trying to catch up. But keep in mind, Michael, Shawn Michaels' stipulation on him. If he shows favoritism towards The Undertaker against Bret Hart, he will be suspended indefinitely from the World Wrestling Federation.
Uh-oh, nobody home. Scott Taylor impressive in this. What a right hand. Scott Taylor looking for the upset. Another right hand. Jerry the King Lawler in all kinds of trouble. Taylor with a drop kick. Look at the King. I don't think he knows where he is. He probably thinks he's back in Memphis, not here north of the border. Scott Taylor now, whipping the King into the ropes. Off the rope, big back body drop.
Jerry the King Lawler in trouble. Scott Taylor going for the upset now. Whips the King into the ropes. Off the ropes. Uh-oh, telegraphed it. Here it comes. The move that Jerry the King Lawler made famous. The pile driver. The patented pile driver. This should be it. Jerry the King Lawler with the pile driver defeats Scott Taylor and his legend son, Brian Christopher, loves it.
That's his son. His son. His heir, if you will. Very proud young man seeing his father victorious here on Shotgun. A great accounting by Scott Taylor, but the veteran of well over 20 years, Jerry the King Lawler, victorious.
Look at this, the king, and it looks like the court jester from King Arthur's court there in the middle of the ring.
Yeah, it's not too big of a stretch there. I don't think Christopher's wound too tight.
Up next, the nasty hog farmers have something to say. We'll find out what it is when we come back.
Hey, UK, this is the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
We're the Headbangers, I'm Thrasher.
This is Mosh.
Hey, UK, I'm Rocky Maivia.
It's all the non-stop excitement
of your favorite superstars.
Us.
In action every week, right here on Sky.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Henry and Phineas, the Godwins.
Listen to this crowd, Kevin. I don't know if it's the music or if they just don't like Arkansas hog farmers up here in Canada.
Well, you see the look on Henry Godwin and Phineas Godwin's face. They don't seem to be too fond of this Canadian crowd.
Unbelievable. Henry and Phineas Godwin have been in a zone the past, month or so. It's going to be interesting to hear what they have to say to Vince McMahon this week on Shotgun.
Henry and Phineas Godwin recently winning the triple threat tag team matchup, which of course means that you then go to this Monday night on Raw in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, where you'll be facing the tag team champions of Stone Cold Steve Austin and Dude Love.
That's right, Mr. McMahon. Me and Phineas went through the Blackjacks and the Headbangers, and this Monday night in Pittsburgh, we get a shot at them belts again against Stone Cold and that freak walking around with him, Dude Love. And when we get done with them boys, then we're going to SummerSlam in the Meadowlands against the LOD. That's right, we're bringing the gold to the Meadowlands.
What makes you think if you're going to be able to defeat Stone Cold and Dude Love for the titles this coming Monday?
I don't think, Mr. McMahon. I know. I told you a while back that the Godwins were going to do things their way. Settle down, Phineas.
Not yet.
And you're actually looking forward to facing the Legion of Doom, considering what you did recently, the LOD. Don't you know they're gunning for you?
Mr. McMahon, I heard them say that we tried to break Hawk's neck. We ain't tried to break Hawk's neck yet. We're just toying with them boys right now. We're priming them up.
Well, you truly hope you're going to be the champions, go to SummerSlam, and then face LOD in a title match.
We're going to SummerSlam with them gold belts around our waist. And LOD, you don't know what pain is. When you broke my damn neck, that was pain. But at SummerSlam, you're going to know what pain is. You're not going to be fit to get in the ring. You're not going to be fit to fight or wrestle or anything. But you might be good for one thing. What is it, Phineas?
Hawk, you sure do got a pretty mouth, boy.
I wonder if Ned Beatty would be interested in being the special guest referee,
no.
Michael.
You had to go there. Up next, the Intercontinental Champion Owen Hart takes on Mankind. But first, let's take you back to Raw. It's Vader versus Shamrock.
What a treat for the Canadian fans. Here we go.
The following world title contest is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. About to enter the arena from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Weighing 227 pounds, he is the two-time Swimming Award winner
but this is a treat. These fans are loving Owen Hart.
His opponent, weighing 287 pounds, Mankind.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you what. Mankind has been very vocal this week. Let's take it back to comments recorded earlier.
Owen Hart is going to be very lucky because although he will take a beating, I'm a little bit preoccupied thinking about the face of Hunter Hearst Helmsley inside a 15-foot high steel cage.
Wow. I'll tell you, I don't think Hunter Hearst Helmsley wants any part of Mankind in that cage match. It's the first time that Helmsley in his career goes within the steel cage walls, and he's going to have to face a veteran of fights just like that. Mankind, certainly a much darker figure than we've seen Mankind take in the form of Dude Love lately, Michael.
That's next week at SummerSlam, and notice Mankind did not carry the tag team championship belt into the ring because, of course,
he's not the tag team champion.
Dude Love it.
Listen to this crowd. I don't think Mankind could care less what part of the world he's in when he's having to face somebody who's charged up in front of the hometown folks, if you will, in Owen Hart.
Sometimes I wonder if Mankind ever knows where he is. He's in his own world, Mankind world. Owen Hart, by the way, next week at SummerSlam has a huge matchup against Stone Cold Steve Austin for the Intercontinental Championship. And I'll tell you what, Austin says if he doesn't take the title away from Owen, he will kiss Owen's backside.
And I've got a feeling that Stone Cold Steve Austin is going to be charged up and ready to go in that one.
Can you imagine if Stone Cold actually has to live up to that stipulation if he indeed loses to Owen Hart? That's got to be perhaps the most embarrassing thing Stone Cold is ever going to do.
And I've got a feeling Owen Hart's going to do everything he can to hold on to that Intercontinental title.
Yes.
Great series of moves and counter moves by both men. Owen Hart controlling things with the left arm.
Also, another member of the Hart Foundation, the British Bulldog, puts the European Championship on the line against the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, who, by the way, Kevin, was defeated for the first time in the WWF last week by Vader on Raw.
Well, put the British Bulldog in that as well. He was not pinned. It was a count-out loss, but I'm sure embarrassing for the world's most dangerous man nonetheless. And I got a feeling he's going to be looking to take out his frustrations with the European title on the line against the British Bulldog.
You know what? If Shamrock wins that match, the Bulldog is going to have to eat dog food in the middle of the ring. Can you imagine?
Well, it might be better than Diana's cooking. No, I don't know.
No. I heard Diana's a great
cook. Mrs. Calgary.
That's right. Miss Calgary, 1997. Here we go now. Mankind working on Owen Hart. Don't forget Mankind's alter ego, Dude Love. We'll be defending the Tag Team Championship along with Stone Cold. Nice takedown by Mankind against the Godwins.
Boy, you even think about touching a Canadian. You're going to get booed out of the building.
There we go. Cover now. Two. Oh. Almost three before Owen pops out. Listen to this crowd. Mankind now working on Owen Hart. This is a non-title matchup. Of course, Owen, the current Intercontinental Champion, as Mankind tosses Owen out of the ring.
You know, Owen's got this date coming up with Stone Cold. He could take quite a bit of punishment here against Mankind this week on Shotgun. I wonder if that'll influence things at SummerSlam.
Oh, my. Mankind blocking himself from going into the steps. Oh, there we go.
Bang, bang.
Owen Hart bang him with the right hand to the side of the head. Here we go again. This match is getting out of control. What's going to happen as Owen Hart tosses Mankind back into the ring? We'll see when Shotgun continues.
SummerSlam. The man from the dark side possesses the gold. But this angry hitman is hell-bent on reclaiming it. SummerSlam. The reigning Intercontinental Champion got the 1-2-3 in the 10-man tag. But the bottom line is a promise this stone-cold killer intends to keep. WWF SummerSlam. Heart and soul.
Just a week away at the Continental Airlines Arena. Tell you what, the main event, Bret Hart against The Undertaker for the championship. If Bret loses, he's out of here. He can never wrestle in the United States again.
Folks from 28 different states and four countries as of now joining us. Folks all the way as far as California, Colorado. Of course, the great fans of New Jersey joining us.
Oh! Spinning heel kick from Owen Hart. Here's the cover. Two, almost three, Mankind kicks out.
And of course, we've got fans joining us from the great country of Canada, Germany, Australia, and New Zealand.
Australia and New Zealand coming all the way over to New Jersey to see SummerSlam?
great World Wrestling Federation fans, we truly are worldwide. It is going to be incredible, just 1 week away. As you said, tickets are just about gone, Michael.
Mankind now with the right hand, Owen Hart. Both of these gentlemen will be in action at SummerSlam. It's going to be an unbelievable event. This has been an unbelievable match. What a takedown. Belly to belly from Owen Hart. Owen Hart says this could be it. He's going up to the top rope.
Owen taking a few seconds to celebrate with the crowd. I wonder if that could be too much time.
Here's Owen off the top rope. Oh! Mankind with a boots to the midsection. Owen in trouble. You were right. Took a little too much time there.
That's the perhaps the disadvantage of being in front of the home folks. He's probably got some family members here with him as well.
Owen Hart now into the, oh, turnbuckle, but he caught Mankind with a big boot. Owen now up on the second rope. Here he comes. Mankind caught him with a claw again. Mankind with a mandible claw. Oh, no.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Look out. Hunter Hearst Helmsley is up on the ring apron. Mankind misses with a right hand. Hunter's got Mankind. Oh, almost a mistake there, but Mankind now gets the claw on Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
He's got it. He's got it.
And there's China on the outside of the ring. She's up on the apron. Owen Hart, though, saves Triple H. The bell rings. This match is over. This could get out of control. Triple H and Owen Hart destroying Mankind in the center of the ring.
Helmsley wants to try. Oh, come on. That's going to cost Helmsley a couple of bucks. This shows me that Helmsley wants nothing to do with Mankind in the cage. He's going to put the pedigree on him and finish it before the cage is even built.
Pedigree from Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Mankind, he could be out cold in the middle of the ring. Look out now. Owen Hart setting up Mankind for the sharpshooter. He needs some help. Mankind needs some help or he might not be able to wrestle at SummerSlam. Oh, my, what's going to happen?
Hey, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
What's he doing?
And look at Helmsley. Helmsley and China are leaving.
What's Stone Cold doing? Mankind's not his partner. Owen doesn't see him. Oh, no, the stunner. Stone Cold hit Owen Hart with the stunner.
This has nothing to do with Mankind. This has to do with that Intercontinental title that Stone Cold's got in his hands.
Stone Cold with the Intercontinental belt screaming at Owen Hart, saying next week at SummerSlam, I'm taking the belt away from you, fair and square.
Next Sunday at SummerSlam, could Stone Cold become the Intercontinental champion?
Unbelievable show this week. Don't forget. This week on Raw, we'll have the results of that closed-door meeting between Brett and WWF officials. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole. Thanks for joining us. Have a great week, everybody.
Goldust. We'll see what Lou Marconi can do here against Brian Pillman, but you know that Brian Pillman, not wanting to have to wear that dress on Raw, is going to have a trick up his sleeve. I've got a feeling all of the Hart Foundation members will have tricks up their sleeve. It certainly could be a very profitable night for the Hart Foundation, or it could also be a very embarrassing night for the leading citizens of the nation of Canada. I wonder what Brian feels about, really feels about Brett's U.S. views, but nonetheless, SummerSlam is going to be very exciting.
Pillman against Lou Marconi now. We should mention that, of course, we have a tremendous broadcast here to whet your appetite for SummerSlam. In action, you'll see Triple H, Hunter Hearst Helmsley take on Jesse James, highlights from the tag team title match from Raw, and a special look at The Undertaker. All that this week on Shotgun. Brian Pillman now working on Lou Marconi, backs him into the ropes, whips him off the ropes now. Here's Pillman with a big elbow. Marconi is down and in trouble.
Marconi learning very quickly to Brian Pillman with some of the hardest chops in wrestling, really laying him to Marconi. In fact, Cornette's looking a little sweaty down there in the Shotgun Saturday night position. Pillman's old chair, what's up with that?
We really don't need to relive that incident,
right,
but suffice to say, Pillman canned off a Shotgun Saturday night.
and obviously not happy at all, voicing his displeasure there to our Shotgun Saturday Night colleagues, Jim Ross and Jim Cornette.
Nice body slam by Brian Pillman.
Look at this. He's pulling Marconi over top of him for a cover. There's two, and he pops out.
Oh, I doubt he does that with Goldust at SummerSlam.
Did you see Marlena jump up on Brian Pillman's back, tearing at his hair? She's going to do anything to defend her man. Speaking of defending her man, how about China? We'll see Hunter Hearst Helmsley in a few minutes, and we know that Helmsley's going to have his hands full with Mankind in the steel cage. I am so psyched up for SummerSlam.
Can't wait. SummerSlam, 7 o'clock Eastern, Sunday night, Continental Airlines Arena. Going to be unbelievable. It's sold out. 20,000 people. Nice neck breaker by Pillman. This could be it. Here's the cover. Hooks the leg. 2 and 3. It's all over. The loose cannon. Brian Pillman defeats Lou Marconi, a tune-up for SummerSlam.
Folks, for 28 states and 4 different countries coming from all over to see SummerSlam at the Continental Airlines Arena. Like you say, Michael, totally sold out.
Still to come, it's not the first time these two teams have met, but this time the Blackjacks are looking even the score with Owen Hart and the British Bulldog.
Plus, we'll see Hunter Hearst Helmsley. He's going to attempt to show Double J Jesse James some manners.
But up next, Brian Christopher, too sexy in action with his alleged dad at his side.
My name is Brackers, and I come from Deutschland. Mein Gewicht ist 300 Pfund. Und wenn ich nach Amerika komme, zu der World Wrestling Federation und die Nation of Domination in den Ring kriege, werde ich sie zerstören!
Anything would grow on 200 pounds of fertilizer. Come on.
Here's Christopher now, backing Darling into the ropes. Nice move by Ace Darling. Uh-oh, Christopher with the reverse nice suplex.
That's for you, Opie.
I think Lawler was one of those Little League dads.
Unbelievable.
Screaming while Brian was pitching or playing third base.
Who is the greatest light heavyweight, and why is he? Huh? Brian Christopher.
I thought it was Scott
Putski. Come on, Brian, teach that punk a lesson.
What about Scott Taylor? Taka Michinoku.
Look at this.
Could be Ace Darling. Could be an upset.
Darling now. Look at this. He's got him covered. Two. Almost three.
Wow. Watch the pipes. Punk's cheating.
Backslide. Here we go.
Come on, Brian.
Two. Almost had him again.
Boy, another near fall.
Oh, missed with the spinning heel kick. Christopher trying to regain control.
Hey, take a look. Get the camera over here.
Oh, come
Wouldn't
on,
you, Lord? Huh? Look at her. Can you get a shot of her right there? Huh? That's your wife. Oh, my apologies.
That's uncalled
for. I bet you were real drunk when you married her, weren't you?
Certainly want to apologize for the comments of Jerry the King Lawler.
I guess you know what they say. Beauty's only a light switch away, huh?
The King, one night only. Thank God.
Look at this. Come on, Brian. Tear him up. Destroy him. Look at this.
Oh.
This is going to be great right here.
Throw a couple of pom-poms in his hand. He's Brian Christopher's cheerleader now.
Oh, yeah. A little too cocky.
Hey. Watch it. He's up on his feet. Turn around again.
Oh, my. Thank goodness.
Come on.
Oh, another drop kick by Darling.
Come on, Brian. You made a big mistake now, punk.
Yeah. Oh. Look at this. This could be it. Cover two. Almost three, but too sexy. Kicks out again.
Come on.
Ace Darling now working on Brian Christopher. Christopher in all kinds
Shut
of trouble.
Up, you morons. Come on, Brian!
Listen to Lawler. He sounds like a cheerleader. Oh, nice move by Christopher.
Finish him off for me. Come on, finish him off.
How can he concentrate?
Here's How can we concentrate?
Everybody watch this right here.
Oh, what a move. Power move by Brian Christopher. Trying to end it now as he goes to the top ropes.
This is it. Get the cameras ready. Take the pictures. Let's see the flash bombs.
Oh, this should be it. Christopher covers. Two
right now.
And three. Too sexy victorious on shotgun.
Is over there. Too sexy. Brian Christopher.
Jerry the King Lawler, the cheerleader outside the ring, watches his alleged son win here on shotgun.
Alleged.
There he is right there.
That's his son. Those people aren't happy with the comments of the King. Neither am I. Let's take another look at how Christopher won this light heavyweight divisional match against Ace Darling, who gave a great accounting of himself. The leg drop off the top rope. Some tense moments, though, for the King and his son.
Brian Christopher victorious on shotgun. Still to come this week, highlights from the tag team title match from the War Zone. Stone Cold Steve Austin and Jude Love defending the belt.
Plus, we'll see the Blackjacks face the former tag team champions Owen Hart and the British Bulldog.
And up next, wow, is he focused, the Phenom, ready for the championship match at SummerSlam.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
She really let Mankind have it. The battle didn't end there, though. Those two superstars, Hunter and Mankind, battled all the way into the crowd, and nothing is settled. Two superstars locked inside a 15-foot-high steel cage this Sunday night at SummerSlam. That lady, Chyna, is going to try to figure out a way to get in.
That's right. Triple H this week on Shotgun taking on this man, Double J, Jesse James. Triple H better not be looking ahead toward SummerSlam, because if he does, Jesse James could pull a big upset here on Shotgun. What about that 15-foot-high steel cage, Kevin Kelly? That seems like, to me, Mankind's element, sort of Mankind's neighborhood.
Yeah, home away from home. We know that Mick Foley grew up on Long Island, but Mankind, Cactus Jack, has spent a lot of professional time inside of steel cages. Helmsley has not had that advantage. Helmsley much more technically superior, but in Mankind's element, Helmsley's going to have to really try to pull out some tricks and some stops. It all focuses, I think, around Chyna. How will Helmsley get Chyna
inside that cage.
The object of the matchup, of course, is to get out of the cage in order to win. But for Triple H, as you mentioned, it may be how to get China into the cage to give him an advantage over Mankind.
Boy, it is going to be great. So many folks are talking about SummerSlam. The buzz on the street about the big event this Sunday night. Folks are so excited. The event itself is sold out.
20,000 people.
You can't see it live. Over 28 states, four countries around the world. Folks are flocking to the event. I know a lot of folks from the UK that are making the trip across the pond to check out the action of SummerSlam. It certainly is going to be great. Three championship matches, seven matches in all. A lot of men putting a lot on the line, not just titles, but also a lot of pride involved. As we see Hunter Hearst Helmsley now, he's got a lot on the line. Backing Double J, Jesse James into the corner. Token slap across the face. Look at China hop right up on the apron. She is always a factor. And Double J turns his attention away from Hunter Hearst Helmsley for a moment. Helmsley able to capitalize. And you see him really letting Double J have it there in the corner. The UK superstar line is up and running right now. The number is 0891-299-888. Maximum cost of the call is £3. And the call costs 50p per minute, regardless of the time of the call. Lateral press and a near fall there by Double J. Remember, folks, if you are under 18, you must have parental permission before calling the UK superstar line. Jesse James controlling things now, controlling the left arm of Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Former Intercontinental Champion will be stepping into the ring against Mankind at SummerSlam. What an event that's going to be inside the steel cage. I'm not sure Helmsley knows what to do with Mankind. He couldn't solve him at the King of the Ring. No matter how hard he tried, Mankind wouldn't stay down. Canadian Stampede, same thing. And I've got a feeling that the war could be settled at SummerSlam, but it may not be the result that Hunter Hearst Helmsley is looking for.
Jesse James holding his own in this matchup against Triple H, Hunter Hearst Helmsley. James unloading now with big right hands to Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Of course, Double J, a U.S. Marine. He fought in the Persian Gulf War. He was a frontline soldier in Kuwait. But now he's getting taken to him by Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Yeah, he should have yelled retreat instead of yelling charge. And he ran right into the boot of Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Look
as we
her.
Take a look at China, 197-pound bodyguard. But I'm wondering if there's a little bit more between China and Helmsley, and I don't like the looks of this at all.
What's she going to do now? Oh, my! What a short clothesline, big right hand from China.
Looked like Double J was just about to throw a right hand of his own, but China beat him to the punch.
And here comes Triple H now outside the ring to go to work on Double J. Look at this. Teamwork between Hunter Hearst Helmsley and China, his bodyguard. Hunter now tossing Double J into the ring the hard way. He's firmly in control of this matchup thanks to that woman, the bodyguard, 197 pounds, China. But Double J now trying to fight back. The men exchanging blows now in the middle of the ring. But again, Triple H breaks the eyes and he regains control.
Such aggressive attitude from Hunter Hearst Helmsley we saw at the King of the Ring.
Oh.
And we could see some more of that inside the steel cage. He'll have to do it for survival. The battle between he and Mankind continued at the Canadian Stampede, Michael. Remember, they battled in the ring, out of the ring, all over the building. Helmsley was a bloody mess. We could see more of that inside the steel cage this Sunday night at SummerSlam.
Cover now. There's two. Little nonchalant. Double J, though, reversal. Hunter pops out after one. And right, once again, Hunter Hearst Helmsley on top of Double J. He never gives Double J any time to get back into it. He's quick like a cat on top of it.
That's what Helmsley's forte is, the technical superiority. But look at this.
Again, China getting involved. Look at this. Another right hand. Double J being manhandled by the bodyguard, China, the Amazon. Triple H now looks like he's going to go for a cover. Here it is. One, two. Double J kicks out. Hunter Hearst Helmsley screaming at the referee. What's going to happen in this matchup? Stay with us. Shotgun continues. Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. Look at Double J.
Hey, he's got some life in his legs now. Fighting back. Here we go.
Look at this. Double J off the rope. But Hunter Hearst Helmsley caught him again. And once again, Triple H and China in control. And there is that pompous attitude we've come to know from the man from Greenwich, Connecticut.
Michael, I'm sure that Hunter's not going to be doing any of that bowing and posing inside that cage. That's for sure. And I know in addition to the great battle that Mankind and Hunter Hearst Helmsley have going for them, what about that eight-man tag? The Disciples of Apocalypse rolling in on them rumbling bikes against Los Boricuas. That's going to be a battle, the eight-man tag at SummerSlam.
Triple H now in control. The question, though, is will he be able to do that to Mankind in the cage on Sunday night? 3 hours of SummerSlam. Kevin, I can't wait. 20,000 people in the Continental Airlines Arena. It's going to be a madhouse.
It is such a great event for the World Wrestling Federation. We are so proud to be broadcasting from the Continental Airlines Arena.
Cover for Hunter now. There's two, but Double J kicks out again.
And the excitement inside will be fantastic, unbelievable. Off the page, as our colleague Jim Ross loves to say. And it will be a history-making event at SummerSlam.
Double J trying to battle back now. We know about, of course, the cage match. We know about the eight-man tag. We know about the three title matches. But I'll tell you the one match that I can't wait to see. The Godwins and LOD.
Look at Double J fire back. And I know you're a big Road Warrior fan from back in the day, Michael. You want to see the Legion of Doom get their hands on the Godwins.
Oh, big elbow. Jesse James now gaining some momentum, trying to take control over Triple H. Jesse James now dancing, and when he gets through a dancing, you know he's in control in the ring. There's the big clothesline, knocking Hunter down in the corner. Hunter slowly up to his feet.
He's looking for China. He's looking for help.
Oh, my. Atomic drop. Gave some of Hunter's medicine back to him. What's he doing now? Oh, it looks like the chart buster, Kevin. If he hooks this, it's over, but there's China. Uh-oh. Hunter with the reversal, the pedigree, it's over. Nobody gets up from the pedigree. Here's the cover, two and three, it's over. Triple H with the win over Jesse James. But the question remains, will he be able to do that to Mankind in the steel cage on Sunday night?
Oh, it is gonna be fantastic at SummerSlam. The pompous Hunter Hearst Helmsley, the Greenwich snob, could get his face rearranged courtesy of Mankind.
Look at that pompous attitude, Kevin.
Take a look at exactly what was the key to Hunter Hearst Helmsley's victory. No surprise, it was China. Looked like Double J was just about to end things, but you see how quickly Hunter was able to turn it around. And the most devastating finishing move in wrestling today, the pedigree, leads Hunter to the win.
Still to come on Shotgun, tag team action is coming your way as the Blackjacks hope to take the Canadian pride out of Owen Hart and the British Bulldog.
Up next, we'll go to highlights of the tag team title match from the War Zone. Stone Cold Steve Austin does some damage to the Godwins. Stay with us.
Hey, UK.
Hey, UK.
You know that Raw is
Raw
war.
Is war.
Raw is war.
You can be a part of the War Zone.
Every Friday night at 10 p.m.
Every Friday at 10 p.m. on Sky Sports 2.
Raw is war.
Raw is war.
Be a part of the War Zone.
You can be a part of the War Zone.
Every Friday at 10 p.m. on Sky Sports 2.
Well, the tag team titles were on the line this past week on Raw. Stone Cold Steve Austin and Dude Love defending against the Godwins. During the tag team title match, Owen Hart and the British Bulldog made themselves very good.
The 557-pound Windham and Bradshaw, the new Blackjacks.
What a matchup to get you ready for SummerSlam. The Blackjacks against the former tag team champions, Owen Hart and the British Bulldog. Oh my, what a match.
Yeah, and you saw the dastardly deeds carried out once again by Owen Hart. In that previous segment, we saw them cost the Godwins, in my opinion, the WWF tag team titles. But you know that Stone Cold can't wait to get his hands on Owen Hart with the Intercontinental title on the line this Sunday at SummerSlam.
Bulldog and his partner, two-time Emmy Award winner and current World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion, Owen Hart.
Davey Boy knows a lot of folks in the homeland of the UK will be tuning into SummerSlam live at midnight across the sea. And he's not going to want to be embarrassed in front of the home folks. Davey Boy spoke very passionately recently on a UK special about how important it is for him to be European champion. And he knows that while Ken Shamrock is double tough, the Bulldog feels he has no business in the same ring with the 18-year veteran, the native of Manchester, the British Bulldog.
I'll tell you what, the Bulldog better not look ahead to Ken Shamrock, because he'll be in for some trouble here against Blackjack Windham. Nice arm drag takedown that time. Another one by the veteran Windham. And now the British Bulldog going to the referee saying, hey, Windham may be pulling my trunks a little bit.
We're back in the States. No home field advantage this week for the British Bulldog and his brother-in-law, Owen Hart.
Speaking of Owen Hart, what about the matchup he has at SummerSlam, putting the Intercontinental Championship belt on the line against Stone Cold Steve Austin?
Austin doesn't win. He's going to have to pucker up and kiss Owen Hart on the rear end. And I know that is something he does not want to do, he does not plan on doing, but I think Owen Hart realizes that his time as Intercontinental Champion could be just about over.
Here we go now, Blackjack Bradshaw into the ring, going to work on the British Bulldog. Bradshaw now whipping Bulldog into the ropes, big boot! The Bulldog in trouble, he heads to the corner, and here comes Owen Hart, his brother-in-law, into the ring to take on Bradshaw.
You spoke about the distraction factor, it looks to me that perhaps the British Bulldog a little bit out of focus. We'll see if Owen Hart has the same problems here with Bradshaw.
Justin Hawk Bradshaw backs Owen Hart into the corner. Bradshaw, of course, a kin, I guess you could say, of the legendary Blackjack Lanza. Of course, Wyndham, the son of Blackjack Mulligan. The Blackjacks were WWF Tag Team Champions back in the mid-1970s. Bradshaw now working on the Intercontinental Champion Owen Hart. Speaking of SummerSlam, Kevin, I cannot wait for the main event. The WWF Championship on the line. The Phenom, The Undertaker, puts the belt on the line against Bret the Hitman Hart.
Boy, I talk a lot of speculation going around. What exactly will Bret the Hitman Hart do if he loses? Of course, if he loses, if he does not become WWF Champion, he says he will never compete in the United States again. And he'll have to think about Shawn Michaels as well as the special guest referee. Remember, if Michaels favors The Undertaker, Michaels will not be allowed to compete in the United States. He'll be suspended indefinitely from competing in the States. I don't know if there will be a winner in that situation. Somebody's going to leave SummerSlam, though, the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Owen Hart now trying to regain control against Blackjack Wyndham. I'll tell you what.
Ooh!
Let's not worry about Bret Hart for a second. Let's talk about the champion, The Undertaker. What is going through the Phenom's head? I mean, he's worried about whether his brother's alive or not.
It's been a very mysterious time for all of us. We've yet to hear what The Undertaker has to say about Kane.
Has
perhaps The Undertaker been doing investigating of his own?
Two. Hart kicks out.
We know Paul Bearer has spoken about having proof of Kane's existence, but maybe The Undertaker has set out on his own journey to try to find his long-lost brother.
Here we go again. Wyndham now after the suplex. Cover two before Owen Hart kicks out. The Intercontinental Champion trying to regain some composure in this matchup against the Blackjacks. Speaking of the Blackjacks, Kevin, I'll tell you what. They're going to be in contention at some point for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. They are a great team.
Ooh, what a clothesline. You said it, Michael. They certainly are. Fantastic.
Cover again
unit.
On Hart. Two. Kick out, though, on Bradshaw.
A win here against the former Tag Team Champions immediately elevates the Blackjacks to title contention.
Here's Owen Hart now. Blackjack Bradshaw off the rope. Spinning heel kick. Owen Hart caught him. And I'll tell you what, as the Bulldog comes in, that may be the move that's going to win this thing for the former WWF champs.
Might also be the move that put Stone Cold Steve Austin down this Sunday at SummerSlam. You know Austin is going to be ready for a fight, though. He does not want to have to kiss Owen Hart on his rear end if he loses. Remember that Owen has already beaten Stone Cold Steve Austin twice before.
That, of course, at the Canadian Stampede, the 10-man tag match. Owen Hart pinning Steve Austin in the middle of the ring, and then back at the Kuwaiti tournament, he actually beat Austin there. The British Bulldog now working on Blackjack Bradshaw. He's the European champion as he tags in now his brother-in-law, Owen Hart. Great teamwork from this team. They were former WWF Tag Team Champions. They work so well together. And I'll tell you what, here's Owen Hart now trying to get Bradshaw over. He's got him in the Boston Crab, a submission hold. But Bradshaw, though, gets his arm over the ropes, and Owen has to release the hold. Unbelievable action. We'll see when Shotgun continues.
There. Here on Shotgun, tag now made. Some tense moments for the Bulldog and Owen Hart early in this contest. They are in control. I understand my broadcast colleague Michael Cole has been called away from the broadcast position. We'll find out what's going on. We're just about at the end of the broadcast. The Bulldog now with Blackjack Bradshaw, reversal of the Irish whip. Wow, the Bulldog sent in hard. Bradshaw, though, slowed from the attack early. A little slow following up. Match is taking its toll on both teams. What a clotheslines. As JR would say, that's a good old Texas lariat. That's a good old Texas lariat, as JR would say. Tag made, here comes Owen Hart. Owen now with Blackjack Bradshaw. Bradshaw, of course, needs to... Wow, what another lariat there. That is something else right there. Boy, he needs to make a tag. Of course, Owen Hart and the British Bulldog, both in singles matches at SummerSlam, defending titles. Tag made, here comes Wyndham. Owen unable to get out. Let's see if Wyndham can capitalize. Owen Hart shot across. Oh, what a backdrop. Lateral press. Bulldog comes in.
Windham foregoing the lateral press to head off the Bulldog at the pass. Suplex, float over. Two and a half. All four men are in the ring now. Referee Mike Chioda admonishing Blackjack Bradshaw. Wait a second. Inside crack. Oh, come on. Mike Chioda, two. Oh, give me a break. Boy, a day late and a dollar short. The referee on that one missing the fact the Bulldog turned it around. I got a feeling the Hart Foundation, folks, has something about something up their sleeve. I don't know what it is. We'll find out what Michael Cole was doing. Folks, we want to say have a great time at SummerSlam. For Michael Cole, I'm Kevin Kelly. We'll see you next week. Kevin Kelly, thanks for joining us.
The following six-man tag team match is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Coming towards the ring, led by the Commandos from South Africa, at a total combined weight of 922 pounds, the Truth Commission.
The Truth Commission still undefeated here in the World Wrestling Federation, and what a show we have for you this week. For the first time ever on Shotgun, a 20-man battle royal. We'll also hear from Shawn Michaels, and we'll take a look back at SummerSlam. Bret Hart, the five-time WWF champion now. He was greeted, Kevin, screaming throngs of fans at the Toronto airport.
We'll take a look at some of that footage later on. It was a hero's welcome, to say the least, for Canada's greatest hero. Five times World Wrestling Federation champion, Bret Hart overcame all the odds at SummerSlam to once again ascend to the top of the World Wrestling Federation.
And what a week in the WWF. Not only did Bret Hart win the WWF Championship, we have a new Intercontinental Champion in Stone Cold Steve Austin, and a new commissioner, a familiar face, Sergeant Slaughter. We'll talk about that a little bit later on in the program. What about the Truth Commission, Kevin? They're huge, 922 pounds combined weight.
Absolutely. The Commandant has been gearing his troops, readying them for battle. Recon will begin, as always, in a Truth Commission matchup. Joining him, Sniper and the Interrogator at 7 feet tall. That is Jack Hill starting things off here for their opponents. Look at the Commandant. Look at that face. Constantly barking out orders. I saw him during the day before SummerSlam, before this past Sunday, putting his troops through the paces. I had a chance to watch a Truth Commission workout, and I can tell you, Michael, it was very intense. He had them attacking one another like tigers.
Sniper working now on George Faust, a big clothesline. Sniper goes about 6'5", Recon about 6'6", and the Interrogator, the big man of the group, close to 7 feet tall.
Well, it's tough with the power. Tough when you're 6'5", and they call you tiny.
The Commandant barking out orders at ringside is the Truth Commission firmly in control of this six-man tag team matchup. This group, I'll tell you what, as we mentioned, undefeated. Very, very impressive in the early goings here in the World Wrestling Federation. Now tries to gain some momentum with a big boot. Now tries a clothesline, but Sniper isn't going anywhere. Faust doesn't have too much mobility, Kevin, as he's knocked down from behind by Recon.
Yeah, perhaps a ground attack would be best for Faust, but well, he's on the ground right now, courtesy of the clubbing forearm applied by Recon on the outside. These three men, so powerful, so agile, a very devastating team.
Oh! Oh!
Watch out!
Oh, oh my, the Interrogator! What a triple team by the Truth Commission! Lee George Faust with that beard. There's the Commandant. Faust here with his beard. Probably use Donna and Blixen to get him out of the ring area and the sled. Sort of like Santa Claus. You understand that reference there?
Yeah, we got it there. Check out that Interrogator. Look at the face on him. So intense. I know World Wrestling Federation action every week going to South Africa, and they're getting to see some of the home folks here. The Commandant leading his troops into battle.
Off the ropes now, the Interrogator knocking Faust to the canvas. Talking about all these different factions, the Nation of Domination, Los Pericos, DOA, and now the Truth Commission, Kevin. How would you rank the Truth Commission up with those other groups?
Well, you've got to put it right in there at the top. The Nation of Domination this past week on Raw displaying some troubles, attacking one of their own. What a shock. Ahmed Johnson was beset upon by his fellow Nation brothers.
And it certainly was a bad scene for Ahmed. I know this week on Raw, we're going to try to get to the bottom of that. There certainly are some rumors about expansion within the Nation of Domination.
And I'll tell you, sources are telling us that there apparently was some sort of a power struggle, a rift between Farouk and Ahmed Johnson. And I guess Farouk went out on that battle. Here comes Dalton Big now, trying to come back against the Truth Commission, working on recon. Big right hand to the side of the head. Cypher comes in to help him out. And here comes the Interrogator, but I guess he's staying in there. Look at this. Power. Watch out.
Oh, man.
Dalton Big in all kinds of trouble. Hooks the leg now. Here's the cover. And three, it's over. The Commandant and his Truth Commission victorious this week on Shotgun. And the Commandant, the leader of this group, loves what he sees. The Truth Commission. Still to come, the first ever Shotgun Battle Royal, including Mankind, Triple H, will be moshing with the Headbangers. And is it Vader time? We'll see.
Plus, we will hear controversial comments from the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
And the King interviews Sable and her man, Mark Miro. What do they got to say? Stay tuned. We'll see.
Oh, yeah. Hey, let's cut out that Burger King stuff right now. That sounds good about now, as a matter of fact.
Because I am the King, and I am out here to get to the bottom of some rumors that are flying around the World Wrestling Federation. And I'm going to bring out a very special couple right now because I got some questions that I want to ask them, and nobody asks questions better than the King. So right now, I want to bring out the lovely couple. The Wild Man, Mark Merrill and Sable.
I'll tell you what, Sable gave 12-year-old Ryan Shattuck a thrill of his life at SummerSlam.
Hey now!
He and Patrick Stevenson were the two winners, the two finalists of the $1 million chance. They won a trip to SummerSlam, had the time of their lives, even though they didn't win that $1 million. They did have a dream come true. Front row seats at SummerSlam, and they picked up a $5,000 savings bond. Great day for Ryan Shattuck. Great day for Patrick Stevenson.
Wow!
What are you wowing about?
Okay. Were you saying something?
Oh, I thought you were talking about Lawler and Miro. Look at Sable.
Yeah.
And there's the Wild Man. Haven't seen him in a while either.
Merrill's on the comeback trail, rehabbing that knee injury. Certainly look forward to his return.
That's enough.
Be quiet, Jerry's talking.
I just wanted to bring you two out here. Now, Mark Merrill, we all remember when you burst onto the scene here in the World Wrestling Federation, high-flying Mark Merrill and Sable. It seems that Sable just kept getting maybe bigger in popularity than you were, Mark Merrill. Now, what I want to know is how that makes you feel to see the WWF take Sable and make her a model and dress her up in all of these little skimpy outfits with, yeah, with all kinds of stuff hanging out everywhere, and then she's parading up and down in front of all of these World Wrestling Federation superstars, you know, back in around the locker room there. How does that make you feel, Mark Merrill?
King, let me ask you a question. Do you think Sable's beautiful?
I do.
That's an easy one. I think even the King could get that one right.
Yeah, I do. So what?
So do I. And so do a lot of other people.
Oh, okay. So I guess you just kind of grin and bear it, I guess. Are you and Mark, are you still a couple?
You know, King, you can't believe all the rumors you hear, and you should know that better than anyone, because you start most of them.
Whoa, a slap in the face.
Oh, is that so, huh?
Never heard a rumor he didn't like.
And as far as my relationship with Mark is concerned, just like any other couple, we have our ups and we have our downs, but everything is just fine between us.
Everything is fantastic, King.
Huh. Oh, everything's fantastic. Okay, how does that make you feel when you see all of these other big WWF superstars around, huh?
Let me answer that, King. You know, I've been out with an injury for 5 months. In just a few weeks, I'm coming back to the World Wrestling Federation.
All right.
And this woman,
This beautiful lady, Sable, is going to be by my side. And we're going to the top of the World Wrestling Federation. And you, my friend, could be the first one on my hit list.
Well, wow. We didn't hear Sable answer that question. Barrow cut her off. But everything appears to be fine on the surface. Editor Vince Russo really investigates the story. Could there be problems in the jungle?
Still to come this week, the first ever shotgun battle royal with the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock. The British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith. The Godwins for Bitters, Arkansas. And the All-American Patriot.
Plus, fellow Canadians welcoming home their hero, Bret Hart, after winning the World Wrestling Federation Championship for the fifth time.
Plus, HBK has a few words for The Undertaker.
And up next, we'll see Tiger Ali Singh, along with his father, take on Bob Holly. That match is next. Stay with us. And a Federation superstar is anxious to return to the UK, of course, September the 20th. Birmingham NEC, folks, the World Wrestling Federation title will be on the line. Bret the Hitman Hart defends against Stone Cold Steve Austin. The European title will be up for grabs as well as the British Bulldog faces Shawn Michaels, The Undertaker to face Ahmed Johnson, and a whole lot more.
Weighing 256 pounds, Tiger Ali Singh.
And there he is, Tiger Ali Singh, an Indo-Canadian with his father, the legendary Tiger Jeet Singh, and also a third member of this wrestling party.
Perhaps the strangest picture I've ever seen, the Iron Sheik, along with Tiger Ali Singh and his father, Tiger Jeet Singh. These men are from different cultures. They are as opposite as you could get. And to see the Iron Sheik with Tiger Jeet Singh and Tiger Ali Singh, who we'll see competing, is a very strange sight.
Listen to the reaction of this crowd here as Tiger Ali Singh, Toronto-born, Canadian-born, holding the Canadian flag. His father was born and raised in India, moved to Toronto about 30 years ago. That's where Tiger was born.
He showed up in Canada. He had $6 in his pocket, and he made a living by competing in strongman contests. He was a very impressively built man. He lifted weights for money at, like, public displays and shows and things like that, and then got involved in the great sport of wrestling, made a career, a huge name for himself in Japan. Tiger Jeet Singh is an absolute legend in the Far East. His son is a chip off the old block. He is a tough, rugged competitor.
I'll tell you what, if he has the tutelage of his father and also the former WWF champion, the Iron Sheik, he's going to be tough to stop. Tiger Ali Singh making a great start in the World Wrestling Federation. He won the Kuwaiti Cup tournament back in the spring. Oh, my! Tiger Ali Singh, Bob Holly, in all kinds of trouble. Nice belly-to-belly. Speaking of Raw this week, what about that big matchup? We just found out... Uh-oh, covered now by Singh. Bob Holly pops out. We just found out that HBK, Shawn Michaels, is going to be back in action for the first time in a couple of months. He is going to be taking on Mankind.
A rematch from In Your House Mind Games. What an unbelievable five-star match that was, folks. How physical of a contest it was. Everybody remembers it. What's going to happen when Mankind locks up with Shawn Michaels? We will find out this Monday on Raw.
And I wonder if The Undertaker is going to be lurking in the shadows watching that matchup. Of course, The Undertaker, we've learned, will meet Shawn Michaels at In Your House in Louisville. WWF Ground Zero In Your House, September 7th in Louisville. Going to be a great matchup.
It appears that it's the first time these two superstars will ever meet. September 7th at Ground Zero.
Oh, Bob Holly
now. Face press.
Look at him working on Tiger Ali Singh. What's going to happen in this matchup? We'll see when Shotgun continues.
Father Tiger Jeet Singh and the Iron Sheik outside. Worried looks on their faces. This would be quite an embarrassment to the Singh family if Tiger Ali came up with the short end of the stick to Bob Holly here on Shotgun.
Nice clothesline for the spark plug. He's going to cover up now. Hooks the leg. There's two, almost three, before Tiger pops out.
Tiger Ali Singh, a great athlete, raised in Canada, Indo-Canadian background, as you said. And he was recruited to play basketball by Notre Dame. I mean, this guy can dunk a basketball with ease. A tremendous all-around athlete, competed in shoot fighting in Japan, now making the transition to the World Wrestling Federation. As you say, the Kuwaiti Cup champion. Definitely very successful so far in his rookie campaign.
SummerSlam, what a great matchup. What a great event, I should say. And we have a new Intercontinental Champion now, Tiger Ali Singh, off the ropes. He's going to cover up Bob Holly now.
Could be it.
Two, Holly pops out. Stone Cold Steve Austin, of course, the new Intercontinental Champion. He defeated Owen Hart at SummerSlam. Owen Hart delivered a pile driver. We understand that Stone Cold, nice drop kick by Holly, Stone Cold at one point was actually paralyzed in his upper extremities. Owen Hart says he showed compassion for Stone Cold at that point. That allowed Stone Cold to roll up Owen and win the championship. Now, we understand that Austin, here's a cover now by Holly on Singh, too, but Singh pops out. We understand that Austin will see a spine specialist this weekend, and we hope to know more about Stone Cold Steve Austin's injury in the near future.
Certainly we'll get the latest updates, folks, on the condition of Stone Cold. Lateral press, two count only. Folks, the UK Superstar line up and running right now at 0891-299-888. Maximum cost of the call is £3. The call costs 50p per minute regardless of the time of the call. And remember, if you are under 18 years of age, you must have parental permission before calling the UK Superstar line.
Bob Holly now pounding away on Tiger Ali Singh, taking control on this matchup.
Well, that front face lock trying to wear him down. Tiger Ali Singh resisting as Holly pulling on him. You can see Holly trying to perhaps take him over. But a change in momentum, that's how quickly Tiger Ali Singh can strike.
Tiger Ali Singh is built. He's put together, Kevin. I think, he gets some experience under his belt. He's going to be a force to be reckoned with here in the WWF.
With
Holly off the ropes.
With the leadership outside, Tiger Jeet Singh and the Iron Sheik, that's going to, really speed that process along.
Listen to the crowd booing Tiger Ali Singh. He calls himself an Indo-Canadian.
You wave that Canadian flag nowadays, you might as well hold up a sign that says, boo me.
What a power move by Tiger Ali Singh.
Well, I can't wait to see that battle royal, Michael. What action it's going to be, folks, in just a little while. Over 20 men fill in the ring. We'll see who perhaps the toughest man in the WWF is.
Shamrock, Bulldog, Mankind, they'll all be there.
Oh, a Bulldog from the top rope. It's all over. That should do it.
He hooks the leg. It's over. Tiger Ali Singh victorious to the pleasure of his father here on Shotgun.
Ali Singh.
What a devastating maneuver. An impressive win. Gotta like this young man's chances here in the World Wrestling Federation. The Sheik and Tiger Jeet Singh raising the hand, very pleased with their student. In fact, let's take another look at the devastating maneuver that led Tiger Ali Singh to victory here on Shotgun.
Look out for Tiger Ali Singh. He's going to be part of the future of the WWF.
The WWF presents the Slam of the Week.
The man possessed. Stone Cold Steve Austin. Here we go.
Welcome back to Shotgun. Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly getting set for this light heavyweight division matchup between Ace Darling and Devin Storm. Had the opportunity to see these two superstars in action a couple of weeks back on Raw.
Although a brief one, it was a matchup featuring two men included in the future of the light heavyweight division. Now, I think it's great what the World Wrestling Federation is doing, Michael. It's giving these light heavyweights a chance to come in from all parts of the world and show their wares right on Raw or on Shotgun. We're not going to have them in some match at the beginning of the night before the cameras roll. For just the audience that's there in attendance that night, we're going to let the whole television audience see the future of the light heavyweight division. And you fans are really shaping who is chosen for this light heavyweight division. Scouts we have full-time now in Mexico and in Japan, and they are really looking for the next young stars in the World Wrestling Federation.
215 pounds or under to be in this division, and here are two of them, Devin Storm and Ace Darling. Tell you what, both these young kids have heads on their shoulders. They both go to college at night, and I understand Devin Storm is training to be a physical therapist. Oh, nice takedown. Here's a cover, quick cover, one before Darling pops out. Nice takedown again. Darling covers this time. Storm pops out after one. Oh, double drop kick.
These men know each other inside and out. They faced each other on the independent circuit in the United States many times. This is a very even contest, and we'll have to wait to see who's the first man to make a mistake, because that's where the opening will come from.
Who's the best light heavyweight right now in the World Wrestling Federation?
So a tough call. The upset scored by Taka Michinoku, I think, puts him on the top of the heap. But you've got Brian Christopher. You've got the great Sasuke. You've got Scott Taylor. All kinds of new names coming in all the time. And these two men definitely will be a factor down the line.
Devin Storm in the green. Ace Darling there in the flower trunks, I guess, or paisley, whatever you'd like to call them.
You got a jacket like that, don't you, Michael?
Yeah, and yeah, I understand you have trousers like that, Kevin. Here we go. Devin Storm now tossing Darlene out of the ring, but Darlene hangs on.
What are you doing looking at my trouser closet?
A little surprise there as Darlene hits Storm in the abdomen with the shoulder. Nice takedown by Ace Darlene. In control now of this matchup against Devin Storm.
You mentioned Devin Storm studying to be a physical therapist. These two high-risk athletes may need a physical therapist after this contest. They really put their bodies on the line.
When you're talking about the light heavyweight division, as we mentioned, nice takedown that time by Storm. 215 pounds or under. If you have somebody that's about 215, say a Brian Christopher or Scott Putski, and then you have somebody maybe even under 200 pounds, a Taka Michinoku, who has the advantage? Do those 15 pounds really make a difference?
Well, there's not a lot of difference in weight, but any difference can mean a lot. But as we saw, Taka Michinoku scored the upset, giving up 20 pounds. So really, I don't think it's much of a factor. But you know what? The best light heavyweight in the World Wrestling Federation may not be here yet. We might see him very soon.
Who may that be?
Well, I don't want to say that, but with the full-time scouts in Japan, hint, hint, and Mexico, the best could be yet to come.
Look at Ace Darlene now off the top rope. Oh, my, what a move. I think he knocked Devin Storm out.
The somersault senton all the way to the floor. And definitely came down hard in the shoulder of Devin Storm.
Tell you what, these light heavyweights treat their body with ill regard. Here we go. Ooh, nice move by Storm that time. And Ace Darlene will be talking a bit higher.
Well, that's definitely a result of the scouting from having faced each other. Take another look at the high-risk maneuver, the somersault senton. Devin Storm felt that one, but now Storm surprisingly back in control.
Here we go now. Big boot to the head. Storm now climbing up to the top ropes. What's he going to do here? He's setting Ace Darlene up.
Taking his time.
Oh, Hurricane Rana. What a move. Ace Darlene in all kinds of trouble.
Showboating to the crowd instead of making the cover, costing valuable time.
Devin Storm won the first matchup against these two on Raw a couple of weeks back. There's the cover. Darlene kicks out.
Kind of a sloppy cover as well. Devin Storm needs to tighten up a little bit here. He could be walking away from this important matchup with a win.
Storm sets him up. Oh, nice takedown. Darlene, man, face first into the mat. Devin Storm, as you said, though, should be a little bit quicker on the cover.
Ace Darlene, we saw give a great accounting of himself last week on Shotgun against Brian Christopher. Take it on the look. Looked like a vertical suplex, but Devin Storm turned it over face first to the mat. So there's been a lot of infighting within the light heavyweight division, and it will continue as the division grows and grows.
Oh, what a right hand. Darlene outside the ring now. Devin Storm warming up a bit. Ooh, drop kick through the ropes, knocks Darlene down.
Referee Mike Chioda admonishing Devin Storm, trying to get him to keep it in. I think Ace Darlene could be just about done here in this contest.
Especially now, it looks like Devin Storm going up to the top ropes. What's he going to do here? Darlene doesn't even see him up there. Here's Devin Storm. Oh, what a move. Hurt himself, I think, as well coming down.
Another somersault senton. This time Devin Storm hits it. And Ace Darlene on the receiving end. This battle is really taking its toll. Where is he going?
What's this action? Take a look again at this move. Ooh.
Well, Devin Storm appraising real estate or something up on the ramp. We see the double feature. And a devastating high-risk maneuver, to say the least.
Storm should have tossed Darlene in a lot quicker than that and tried to pick up a pin here.
Here we go.
Now he's going to go for the cover. Two. Darlene kicks out. Probably would have had him if he had tossed him back in the ring and went for the cover about another 30 seconds earlier instead of showboating.
I'll tell you what. After watching this matchup, whether he wins or loses, Devin Storm is going to look back and say, boy, I missed some golden opportunities to end this. It'll be back to the drawing board for both men after this contest. They'll have to study the videotape and try to learn something from this matchup.
If he hits this, it's all over, but no. Darlene moves out of the way, and now Devin Storm finds himself in trouble.
You're also seeing a lot of WWF superstars around the monitors during these light heavyweight matches. They want to see what these young men, what these lighter men have to do, and they're going to see if they can pick up some of these great moves.
Oh, look at this. Hurricane Rana. Hooks the leg. Here's a cover. Oh, Devin Storm kicks out. Almost had him. Nice move by Ace Darlene that time. Another nice move by Darlene. Here's a cover again. Only two.
The body scissors into the victory roll. Another near fall for Ace Darlene. Now seizing the momentum. Going up top. Looking to end things here on Shotgun.
Oh, but the second time now, Devin Storm stops Darlene from coming off the rope. Smart move by Storm.
Both men in their early 20s, really just at the dawning of what could be a great career in the great sport.
Devin Storm now up on the ropes, working on Ace Darlene. What's he going to do here? Oh, he missed.
Tried the hurricanrana.
Oh, that stings.
Darling with the block. No give in the canvas.
Look at this, sunset flip. He's got him. Two. Oh, no. Devin Storm kicked out again. I don't know how he keeps doing this, folks. Ace Darling now. Set to roll him up, it looks like. Setting up for the German suplex. No, nice reversal. Here's the cover. Two and three. Devin Storm victorious over Ace Darling here on Shotgun.
No shame, though, for Ace Darling in defeat. A very even contest. And, Michael, every time I see new faces in the light heavyweight division, it gets me more and more excited. I know as the scouts continue to send the great talent from all parts of the world, we are going to see a champion crowned, I understand, sometime in 1998. It's going to be a great future in the light heavyweight division.
Devin Storm victorious here in Shotgun. This is how he did it. Nice reversal over Ace Darling. Covers him up and gets the victory. A big win in the light heavyweight division for Devin Storm. Still to come, the first ever Shotgun Battle Royal with the leader of the Nation of Domination, Farouk. His former partner, Savio Vega of Los Pericuas. Rockabilly will be here. And Crush from DOA.
Plus, Bret Hart is engulfed by a sea of Canadian fans at the Toronto Pearson International Airport.
And up next, Shawn Michaels being Shawn Michaels. Here we go. Battle Royal time on Shotgun.
Ladies and gentlemen, participants in the 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal. First of all, from Bitters, Arkansas, Henry and Phineas Gunsland.
Those two men are lucky they survived the battle with the Legion of Doom at SummerSlam.
From Brooklyn, New York, the Brooklyn Brother.
Haven't seen him in a while.
Boy, this ring is going to be filled. 20 superstars.
He's got a good T-shirt on.
Please. Mets all the way.
Although I think Babe Ruth wore that one.
Accompanied by China from Greenwich, Connecticut, the 1997 King of the Ring, Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Talk about a battle royal. What about the cage match between him and Mankind at SummerSlam?
Helmsley's lucky he's still in one piece. Oh, my! Moshe's Thrasher.
Thrasher, the Headbanger.
We get ready for the battle royal. Let's go back to the war zone where Shawn Michaels received a mixed reaction.
Accompanied by the Hunky Top.
Back to the battle royal entrances here. This is Rockabilly along with his manager, the Honky Tonk Man.
You know the Honky Tonk Man would love to have Rockabilly win the Shotgun Battle Royal.
Uh-oh. Here he comes, Del Wilkes, the Patriot.
September 7th at WWF Ground Zero for the World Wrestling Federation Championship.
And here comes the England Zero.
A British Bulldog.
Well, the British Bulldog did not quite get the hero's welcome his brother-in-law, Bret Hart, got as 1,500 Canadian fans packed the Toronto Pearson International Airport.
Fans cheered, awaiting the arrival of their hero, Bret Hart. And once the Hitman arrived, it was chaos, as fans swarmed to him like bees on honey.
Bret told the crowd he did what he set out to do, winning the WWF Championship for a fifth time. Here he comes, Mankind. I'll tell you what, this week on Raw, what a matchup. Mankind versus Shawn Michaels.
Think about it. Mankind's going to receive a tremendous ovation. What kind of ovation will Shawn Michaels receive? I bet it's a lot different when these two superstars meet this week on Raw.
Uh-oh. There he is. Former partner of Mankind, Vader.
He's the biggest fan in there, not Paul Bearer, but Vader is. Vader at 458, the biggest man in the Battle Royal. An excellent chance to be victorious, Michael.
I'll tell you what, Paul Bearer again telling us he has information on The Undertaker's brother, Kane. It's going to be unbelievable to see if Kane really is alive.
Wow! What an ovation! Oh, he looks like he's in the zone, Michael. This could be trouble for the other 19 guys. Here we go!
We're underway with the first ever Battle Royal on Shotgun. Now, the object of this thing, Kevin, is basically to toss your opponent or one of the opponents over the top rope.
Yeah, it's a drive to survive. Be the last man standing and you are victorious. Try to avoid being tossed over the top rope and look for members of different factions. factions to be teaming up here. We have members of Los Boricuas, DOA, and of course the Nation of Domination well represented here.
Outside the ring, of course, Paul Bearer, China's out there, also the Iron Sheik and Honky Tonk Man. Mankind now, what's he going to do? Oh, Phineas hitting the Patriot from behind.
Mankind seemed a little reluctant to let the Patriot have it. Phineas got one, though, not shy about that at all.
And there's Shamrock and the Bulldog on the other side of the ring. Farouk now getting involved, trying to toss Ken Shamrock out of the ring.
Farouk now helping Shamrock's first battle royal. And he and the Bulldog are tied up in the ropes. It's a real test of strength. Obviously, unfinished business from SummerSlam.
There goes Shamrock, and there goes Bulldog. They're both out.
Farouk with the helping hand. Both men set out to the floor.
Both have been eliminated. The Bulldog and Shamrock, the first out here in this 20-man battle royal. What does winning an event like this do for the winner?
Well, it certainly is a great momentum boost. Ken Shamrock disappointed in his first battle royal. I know Commissioner Slaughter had a long talk with Ken Shamrock on Monday following Shamrock's controversial actions at SummerSlam.
There's Vader in Triple H now to getting a breather in the corner, but Hunter Hearst Helmsley going right at it now with Vader. And here you see Farouk and D'Lo of the Nation teaming up on Los Boricuas. Now Phineas and Mankind.
I understand that Vader very upset with Hunter Hearst Helmsley. You know he'd love some revenge here in this battle royal.
I can't believe it.
There's Crush now.
I can't believe it.
Patriots got Sal Sincere for the tights, and he goes all the way outside.
Sal Sincere, the third man out of this battle royal. Of course, Shamrock and the Bulldog eliminated earlier. The Headbangers now. Who's that?
That's Mosh.
Mosh
could be gone, but Thrasher to make the save. Look at that. That's teamwork for you.
So you see teams forming, and you see teams that have been together working out to help each other, too.
I've noticed a lot of different men going after the Patriot.
Well, he did beat Bret Hart and Raw a couple of weeks ago. D'Lo Brown now out of the ring. He's tossed out. So he's out of the Battle Royal. But the Patriot has beaten Bret Hart once before.
Absolutely. But that does not mean that jealousy does not exist. We know Bret Hart is none too pleased about having to face the Patriot. But I think that could be concern out of losing his title, not the jealousy factor with the other WWF superstars.
There's the Patriot getting a breather now, Thrasher was almost out of the ring.
Thrasher with the last second save, little self-preservation action. Of course,
there's
we know
Farouk
it, boy, on September 7th, we are going to see Farouk.
Oh, there goes the brawler.
Savio Vega and Crush all entering the ring in a triple threat match. The captains of all three factions will be leading a battle, the triple threat match on September the 7th.
There goes Miguel Perez of Los Boricuas out of the ring. And here's Hunter Hearst Helmsley in terrible trouble as China looks on.
She's inching closer and closer. I bet she'll do anything she can to keep Hunter in.
There's Mankind and now Crush, both in trouble. Savio Vega now helping Mosh from the Headbangers.
Trying to get Crush out of there. Savio Vega trying to really get Crush out of there. He does. And now look.
Chains push both Savio and Crush out of the ring. Shotgun will be right back. And Kevin Kelly, Vader, Triple H, Mankind, the Sultan, the Patriot left in this battle royal.
Certainly a lot of bodies flying out of the ring. Vader looking to settle an old score with Hunter Hearst Helmsley. The Patriot having to fight off both men for the better half of this contest.
Del Wilkes now, the Patriot, trying to get a good grip here on Vader, but Triple H comes in from behind to help out Vader. Now the big right hand to the side of the head of the Patriot as Mankind works on the Sultan in the corner.
Here's two men that you know would love to have the chance to face Bret Hart for the WWF title.
Unbelievable. Bret Hart, what a reception in Canada, not only in Toronto, which we saw earlier, but in his hometown of Calgary.
Certainly was a great celebration for the entire nation of Canada. No time to celebrate, though. Bret Hart to face the Patriot, and look at Mankind. Patriot getting set to go out.
Look at Hunter Hearst Helmsley now, trying to toss the Patriot over the top rope. Unbelievable action.
Listen
Vader getting
crowd.
A breather.
Patriot
with a shot to the kidney.
Fired back. Here comes the Patriot. But watch out for the Sultan from behind. Sultan's going to dump him. The Patriot will be
in trouble. There's Vader and Mankind. The Patriot in all kinds of trouble.
Mankind's on the verge of being eliminated as well.
Look at this. The Sultan now working on Del Wilkes to the Patriot. Mankind and Vader going at it on the apron.
And Michael Hunter Hearst Helmsley back in the corner. Helmsley's absorbed a lot of punishment. Well, Vader's absorbed a little bit as well.
Low blow. And Sultan now still working on the Patriot. Those two have been going at it now for minutes and minutes in this battle royal. I guess Sultan still upset he lost to the Patriot on Raw this past week.
Absolutely, the Sultan's first loss in the WWF. And I can't wait till Ground Zero, the first time Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker meet one-on-one.
Uh-oh, oh, DDT! Hunter's in trouble.
And don't forget, right around the corner, Louisville, Kentucky. It's WWF Ground Zero in your house. The Patriot and Bret Hart for the championship. A three-hour program. Of course, we talked about Bret the Patriot. We talked about the triple threat match. Farouk, Savio, and the Crushes. We see the Patriot was starting to come back before the Sultan knocked him down. And of course, you mentioned Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker. First time ever that these two have met. Look at this.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley going to get put out here by Mankind. But Hunter able to keep on his feet. Maybe not for long, though. Look, China's starting to move.
Triple H, he's almost on the apron. Here he is. Mankind now hammering away at the abdomen of Triple H, trying to knock him down to the floor.
I'm not so sure if Hunter was to go to the floor now, if that would be considered being eliminated. Seems like he stopped his momentum on the apron long enough.
Mankind with a boot underneath the chin, as you see now the Sultan invader over in the corner. The Patriot catching a breather for himself here.
You know, the Sultan has just about gone through this match untouched. He has battled just about everybody. Oh. And now, Vader, with the first time I've seen the Sultan on the receiving end in this entire battle royal.
Now the Patriot caught his breath there. Second win now, working with Mankind. What a kick! To knock Vader down like that, that has to have some force in it.
A super kick. Felled Vader as Patriot and Mankind are looking to double team and eliminate Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Look at this. Look at this double team effort as the Patriot now gives up on that and walks over to the center of the ring once again, working on the Sultan. Tell you what, I know you're not a betting man, but if you were a betting man, who do you take? Shawn Michaels or The Undertaker?
I don't know. And I don't know if Shawn Michaels wants that bet or that match. Did you see how quickly he dashed out of town when he heard The Undertaker's music this past Monday?
Here comes the Patriot now, on fire. That red, white, and blue running through his veins. The clothesline to the Sultan. Here's Triple H now, whipping Mankind into the ropes. Big elbow. Mankind in trouble, and so is the Patriot. Vader with a big boot to the midsection.
Vader victorious in many battle royals in his career. He and the Sultan, the two biggest men in there.
Uh-oh, sleeper hold. If he locks this in, this could be it. But if he does lock this in and the Patriot Del Wilkes is in trouble, then you got to get somebody to pick him up and lift him up over the rope.
I don't think it wouldn't be too hard to do.
Mankind.
Everybody waiting for himself.
Hunter's out, but Mankind hung on.
Wow, what agility. Watch out.
No. Oh, Vader knocks Mankind out. And now Mankind and Triple H along with China outside the ring. Oh, man. Double team effort by Vader in the Sultan.
So now the last three men in this battle royal here on Shotgun are Vader, the Sultan, and the Patriot. Patriot with no friends in there for sure.
Listen to this crowd, Kevin. The adrenaline's got to be pumping in Del Wilkes, the Patriot's veins right now as he gets set to take on the Sultan and Vader.
He's got to try to think of a strategy quick. He's got to get on his horse or it'll be a short-lived memory here in the battle royal.
This crowd is jacked. Here comes the Patriot battling out of the corner now against Vader and the Sultan. Look at him go.
Whoa. Oh.
Double team effort. Off the ropes. Oh, what a clothesline. Double clothesline. Here's the Sheik up on the apron.
There you go.
He got his all right.
Watch
out. Here's the Sultan. See you later. Here's Vader. Clothesline. See you later. The Patriot wins. What a victory for Del Wilkes, the Patriot, here on Shotgun as he gets ready for the championship match against Bret Hart and In Your House, September 2nd.
The Patriot has seized the momentum of the World Wrestling Federation. Everyone in this crowd is on its feet as the Patriot celebrates his win in the Battle Royal here on Shotgun. What a battle!
Don't forget, this week on Raw, it's Mankind versus Shawn Michaels. What a battle. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole. Thanks for joining us, folks. Shotgun. I'm Michael Cole along with Kevin Kelly. What a show we have for you this week.
From Calgary,
King Lawler with a special interview with light heavyweight Scott Putski. What a week it's been in the World Wrestling Federation. Shawn Michaels debuted his, quote, insurance policy. There's a new member of the Nation of Domination, and Brian Pillman once again will have to wrestle in a dress.
I'll tell you what, the internet, the dirt sheets, they're all talking about Raw this past week, Michael.
From Hollywood, California, weighing 260 pounds,
the first couple of the World Wrestling Federation, Goldust and Marlena. It is because of this couple that Brian Pillman has been prancing around in wrestling rings in a dress the past couple of weeks, Kevin.
Yeah, it's unfortunately for Mr. Pillman a trend that is going to continue. Goldust and Marlena, Goldust victorious at SummerSlam. Hey, Pillman made the deal, and he's got to live up to his end of the bargain, but I don't think he ever envisioned it going this far thanks to Commissioner Slaughter.
That's right. Brian Pillman hasn't wanted to wrestle in a dress, but let's take you back to Raw this past week. Brian Pillman forced out onto the runway to wrestle in that strapless dress. Of course, he didn't want to go out, but Commissioner Slaughter made sure that he headed toward the ring for a matchup with Flash Funk.
And then Brian Pillman got a look-see at the work of the Golden Handicam, courtesy of Goldust and Marlena. The look of disbelief captured the hidden camera video of Pillman trying to don the dress. But obviously, Brian Pillman snapped closer and closer to psychotic.
And Flash Funk rolled up Pillman, got the pinfall and the victory, and Brian Pillman went ballistic. And you know what that means, Kevin?
It's another week of Brian Pillman in a dress on Raw. And the one man I do not want to be is the person who has to face Brian Pillman. Because Pillman wants nothing more than to get out of this dress. He can't until he wins. And you can see he's slipping closer and closer to going over the edge. And listen to this crowd.
Chanting USA for this matchup with Goldust and Owen Hart, two former Intercontinental Champions, getting set to meet here on Shotgun.
Owen Hart, we're not in Canada anymore. Obviously, listen to this crowd. Goldust egging them on. But I'll tell you what, Goldust, I think, is going to have eyes in the back of his head because Brian Pillman is here. Lurking around, haven't seen him in a while though, and you know, with his affiliation with the Hart Foundation, he could be down here at the ringside area at any moment.
How embarrassing this must be for Brian Pillman. I mean, a former NFL football player, played with the Cincinnati Bengals. One year he was actually voted the most courageous player on the Bengals, beating out players like Boomer Esiason and Chris Collinsworth. And I'll tell you what, Kevin, now he's prancing around the wrestling ring in a dress. Can you imagine what some of his ex-teammates must be thinking?
Well, he's never had too stable of a grasp on reality, and the self-esteem is out the window, I'm sure of that.
Goldust here locking up with Owen Hart. Owen Hart, of course, dropping the Intercontinental Championship at SummerSlam to Stone Cold Steve Austin after he delivered a pile driver. Austin was temporarily paralyzed. Owen Hart showed some compassion to Stone Cold. It allowed Stone Cold to roll up Owen and win the Intercontinental Championship.
A real concussive-type blow on the neck. Austin under the care of a spine specialist right now, determining the severity of the neck injury. But as it stands right now, Michael, Stone Cold will be part of the Fatal 4-Way with his tag team partner, Dude Love, coming up WWF Crown Zero on September 7th.
Here's Goldust now gaining some momentum against Owen Hart. Goldust himself, a former Intercontinental Champion here in the World Wrestling Federation. Of course, the son of the legendary American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And Dustin's dad and mom divorced when he was 4 years old. He lived with his mom for a time in Texas before moving to Charlotte to live with his father. And that's where he learned the wrestling business. Owen Hart now pounding away at Goldust in the corner. Owen Hart, of course, began his career with his dad, Stu, in Canada. Nice big back body drop by Goldust. Owen Hart now in trouble. Nice takedown arm drag into the armbar now for Goldust. Goldust says that the character gave him the opportunity to step out of his father's spotlight and develop his own sense of being a wrestler. For so many years, he'd been in the shadow of his father, the great Dusty Rhodes. Dustin says Goldust gave him the opportunity to actually step out of that shadow. Owen Hart now in Goldust in the middle of the ring. Here's Owen Hart, very athletic, very technical wrestler. Nice takedown. Of course, Owen Hart got his start in the mid-1980s in Canadian Stampede Wrestling, of course, under the tutelage of his father, Stu.
Certainly did. All of the Hart family competed at Calgary. And, of course, this Monday, we will see Owen Hart in tag team action along with his partner, the British Bulldog, to take on the Legion of Doom. But, Michael, everybody's talking about what's going on Raw this week. After what happened last week, the tag team matchup that will feature The Undertaker teaming with Mankind, of all people, to battle Shawn Michaels and Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
That's this week on Raw. And don't forget Ground Zero, as we mentioned. It's going to be great. The Patriot takes on Bret Hitman Hart for the WWF Championship. And of course, for the first time ever, The Undertaker meets Shawn Michaels, Ground Zero, September 7th in Louisville.
It's certain. It's a lot like interleague play in baseball, a real treat for the fans. First time ever. Wow. On Sunday, September the 7th.
Slap across the face by Goldust. Stinging Owen Hart. Now he starts to work on the left arm.
That's no love tap, though. That's a pretty firm right hand, if you know what I mean. Goldust has done an excellent job of taking Owen Hart down, keeping him grounded, and so far out-wrestling the Slammy Award-winning. You know, I bet Owen Hart feels a bit naked out there without that Intercontinental title around his waist. It's really stuck in his craw that he showed compassion to Stone Cold Steve Austin. It cost him his precious title.
Here's Owen Hart now off the ropes. Oh!
Insecurity! Did you hear that?
Man! To the right side of the head of Goldust, and now Goldust in all kinds of trouble. Owen Hart still stinging, though. That left arm in serious pain. Across the sternum now with the leg. Owen Hart rolls the Goldust over. Here's the cover. Two before Goldust kicks out.
Goldust in control of the momentum, but you see how quickly Owen Hart can change things. The Enziguri, change of fortune.
Oh, neck breaker. Here's a cover again on Goldust. There's two, almost three. Goldust kicks out again, and now Goldust trying to gain momentum from this capacity crowd as Marlena looks on.
We'll see how Owen Hart reacts. He's not in Canada. He's planted firmly in the States.
Listen to this crowd. What's going to happen in this matchup between Owen and Goldust? We'll see when Shotgun continues. We've got Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. Owen Hart now in control of this matchup against Goldust, but this has been a classic battle.
It certainly has been back and forth. A great way to start off the broadcast. Later on, we'll see Vader go one-on-one against Hunter Hearst Helmsley. And here comes the sharpshooter.
Uh-oh, setting him up now for the sharpshooter. If he turns Goldust over here, it's going to be all over. Goldust struggling to stay on his back.
Goldust also has got to be careful not to let that right shoulder go down. That's a pinning combination.
Goldust with a shot to the eye that time. Breaks the potential sharpshooter, but he's still seeing stars. Oh, big kick that time. Owen Hart in trouble now.
Not those Hollywood stars he's used to seeing either.
Oh, big clothesline.
Got to watch out for that golden handicap in your locker room, Michael Cole. You never know.
That's
where
right.
Goldust and Marlena will strike.
Worried about that before getting dressed for the program as Goldust now goes up to the ropes. There we go. Look out, though. Loose cannons in ringside, Kevin.
Brian Pillman.
Brian Pillman is heading to the ring. Looking around outside the ring.
Look at that
loose cannon out there chasing Marlena.
Look at the maniacal look in Pillman's eyes. We told you, he's getting closer and closer to snapping.
Boom. Nice reversal by Goldust. Big clothesline. Here's the cover now on Owen Hart. There's two. Owen Hart kicks out, but there's Pillman up on the apron of the ring. Catches a big right hand from Goldust. Pillman clean for that spinning heel kick. Owen Hart should do it here. Hooks the leg. There's two and three. It's all over. Owen Hart with the victory would give the assist to the loose cannon, Brian Pillman.
Unfortunately, that does not change Pillman's standing. Despite the fact he assisted Owen Hart winning here on Shotgun, Pillman still has to wear that dress. He will once again this week on Raw is War.
Owen Hart victorious here on Shotgun, defeating Goldust after Brian Pillman, the loose cannon, headed down to ringside. Unbelievable. Owen Hart, of course, victorious over Goldust here on Shotgun. Take you back now. Take a look at what happened at the end of this matchup.
Well, Goldust and Owen Hart had a battle. Pillman, of course, comes down. He gets a nice how do you do. But then there, Owen Hart with the spinning heel kick. You see right across the bridge of the nose, KO'd Goldust, and that was the win.
Still to come on Shotgun, will Vader be able to drop the Vader bomb on King Hunter Hearst Helmsley? I doubt it if China has anything to say about it. What great action here in the World Wrestling Federation, including the new light heavyweight division. Such superstars as Scott Putski, Takami Shinoku, and of course, Brian Christopher.
I wonder if Brian Christopher's dad, Jerry Lawler, ever took him to Discovery.
Dad.
Father, real deal.
You don't know that.
I most certainly do.
From Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 209 pounds, too sexy, Brian Christopher.
What do you do, sit around the Lawler's Christmas dinner table?
Well, you know, if I did, I would see them exchanging presents, you know, father to son. And they are. It's a matter of fact. And it's, for whatever reason, Lawler has made it a point to not want to admit it. Brian Christopher has made it a point to not want to admit it. And I think it's nothing more than just to try to aggravate someone like me, a journalist who just says, okay, come on, we know it's the facts, we know it's the truth, just say it, please, we're begging you.
And speaking of Jerry the King Lawler, we'll see him a little bit later in the broadcast. He's going to interview Scott Putski, a rival of Brian Christopher's, as you see Christopher now unloading on Tony Williams in this light heavyweight matchup. Nice suplex that time by Too Sexy, Brian Christopher. He goes 209, of course, the weight limit here in the light heavyweight division, 215.
A great opportunity for he and Scott Putski to showcase their skills at WWF Ground Zero, Sunday, September 7th. But Christopher's hot because Taka Michinoku pulled the upset a couple of weeks ago on Raw, and Christopher's going to want to get back right on the winning track.
Inverted atomic drop. If Christopher isn't careful this week, he could lose to Tony Williams. Big drop kick, and Too Sexy's out of the ring over the top rope.
Well, Tony Williams is a tremendous athlete. He and Christopher have both competed in the USWA, United States Wrestling Association in Memphis. They're not strangers to one another. A very even contest. What a high-impact maneuver there from Tony Williams.
Let's take a look now at this action. These light heavyweights flying all over the ring. Big drop kick knocking Brian Christopher over the top ropes.
And then, of course, the plancha there over the top rope. Great elevation. Tony Williams with springs in his legs.
This is Too Sexy, Brian Christopher working on Tony Williams. Irish whip across the ring. Nice leapfrog by Williams that time, but Christopher caught him. Ooh, down across the top rope. Brian Christopher, so smart for such a young wrestler. He's really going to be a superstar here in the light heavyweight division. Christopher from Memphis, Tennessee, 209 pounds, working against Tony Williams. Williams whips Christopher off the rope. Nice leapfrog that time. Another one. Here comes Christopher. Big drop kick by Tony Williams. In control now of this matchup. Speaking of the light heavyweight division, we understand sometime in the near future there's probably going to be a tournament to crown a light heavyweight division champion. And I have to say, Brian Christopher is going to be right there near the top in that tournament.
Every time I see Christopher do that move, it gives me shudders. That is one of the most painful maneuvers I've ever seen. And Tony Williams on the receiving end out of the full Nelson, face first DDT, absolutely devastating.
And the search for light heavyweights has not concluded in the World Wrestling Federation. Ooh, nice move. I understand Kevin scouts around the world looking for possible contenders in the division. Here's a cover, two before Williams kicks out.
Full-time scouts in Mexico and Japan scouring the globe for the greatest light heavyweights, and those men will be making their way to the World Wrestling Federation in the next weeks and months. And Michael, a lot of people say, who's the favorite in the division? I have to say, the man favored right now may not even be here yet.
Well, who could that be?
Well, there's a lot of big names floating around.
Oh, what a drop kick off the second rope. Tony Williams in trouble. Too Sexy Brian Christopher, as I said, he's going to be a contender for the championship. Backs Williams now into the rope. Off the rope comes Williams. Christopher misses with a right hand. Uh-oh, look at this. Nice reversal. DDT. Christopher in trouble.
You can see Williams, though, still feeling the effects of Christopher's high-impact attack on his neck. A little slow over the top of the crucifix, but still able to apply the DDT.
Williams tossing Christopher across the ring into the turnbuckle. Oh, there's a mistake by Tony Williams. Christopher really has the head on his shoulders. He'll capitalize here.
I think Williams might just about lose his.
Oh, what a DDT off the rope by Brian Christopher. Too Sexy now going where he feels at home. That's the top rope. What's he going to do here? Christopher says he's ready. Tony Williams is in trouble. Oh! Laying across the sternum. Covers up. This is it. It's over. Too Sexy victorious on shotgun.
Well, we'll have to see what Scott Putski has to say about his opponent, Brian Christopher, coming up WWF Ground Zero a little later on as Brian Christopher's dad, Jerry Lawler, conducts that special interview here on shotgun.
Let's take a look, Kevin, at what happened at the end of this matchup.
What an even contest it was. But there, the drop kick off the second rope, and that's where Christopher sees the momentum. Look now, the reverse DDT. Then from there, the leg drop off the top led Christopher to the win.
Still to come on shotgun, will it be Vader time or will his time run out when Triple H delivers the pedigree?
And up next, we'll hear that special interview with Scott Putski and Jerry Lawler.
You bunch of rednecks.
Talks a lot about,
well, Southern people.
Yes.
Blue collar humor. Very funny man.
I want to bring a young man down here because I got some very serious questions. Some very serious questions I want to ask him. I'm talking about none other than a gentleman who's competing in the light heavyweight division, Scott Putski. Come on down here, Scott.
Come on, Lawler, say it. He's going to face my son at Ground Zero.
Here he comes, the son of Hall of Famer Ivan Putski, Scott Putski. And as you mentioned, September 7th, Louisville, WWF Ground Zero in your house. Scott Putski trying to settle a feud with Lawler's alleged son. We saw him earlier, Brian Christopher.
There you go with that alleged again. There's no allegations about the fact that Putski's making women swoon all over the world.
This coat, pal. Let me tell you something. If you don't let go of that coat right now, or by the time I count to three, you're going to be in serious trouble.
Scott looks scared. Lawler's been practicing, I understand.
For what?
I'm waiting.
Count to three.
You don't even know how to count to three. Let go of the coat. Okay. Have your little fun, pal. Now let's say this. You're not going to have any fun because you're competing in the light heavyweight division. One, two. You're competing in the light heavyweight division, and you know that Brian Christopher is eventually going to be going for the gold.
What about me?
Yeah, what about you? That leaves you out in the cold as far as I'm concerned. You don't have a chance because you're outclassed.
I'll tell you what, Jerry Lawler. If you keep your nose out of my business, which you probably won't, I'll punk your kid right in the middle of the ring, one, two, three, and I'll have the gold.
Wow. Even Scott Putski knows that Christopher is his son.
You're a fine-looking young man. Of course, you're not in the Brian Christopher category yet, but I'm going to tell you something. At Ground Zero, all I'm going to do is sit there and watch Brian Christopher take you apart. You know what I'm talking about? He is going to take you apart, Scott Putski.
Oh, look out.
Watch out.
Oh, no.
Turn around.
From behind, Brian Christopher.
Putski getting worn out once again by the father and son duo. And now look, we saw this maneuver earlier.
Oh! Kevin, what's going to happen at Ground Zero when Christopher takes on Putski one-on-one to settle this feud? And you know the king's going
to
be around.
Next, look at this. This is just a little sample of what's going to happen to you at Ground Zero. One-on-one, Scott Putski.
It's two-on-one, King. What are you talking about?
Scott Putski never had a chance.
You people are looking at the new light heavyweight champion right here. Get that trash out of the ring.
Unbelievable.
Garbage.
Scott Putski being tossed out of the ring by too sexy Brian Christopher.
What an embarrassing scene. Brian Christopher and his father, Jerry the King Lawler. Scott Putski is going to be there on September 7th. And he's going to be looking to do exactly what he said. Punk out Brian Christopher.
And Lawler calls himself a journalist. We'll be right back.
The WWF presents the Slam of the Week.
Look out! A backbiter!
Right here, Bret Hart thought he had some backup. Thanks to the commissioner, that didn't happen. WWF champion. The Patriot beat Bret Hart just 1 week ago. Can he do it on September the 7th?
That was the WWF Slam of the Week.
Welcome back to Shotgun, Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. Let's take you back now 2 weeks to the war. Here they come, two members of the nation, D'Lo Brown and Kama Mustafa, set for a matchup with 8-Ball and Skull of the Disciples of Apocalypse. No other members of the factions will be at ringside. Commissioner Slaughter laying down the law. You're only allowed to the ring if you're actually battling in the event for that evening. I'll tell you what, Kevin, what is going on with Rocky Maivia? I mean, you know Rocky well. I mean, you've known him over the years. What is going on with Rocky?
It disturbed me greatly to see Rocky Maivia do what he did in joining the Nation of Domination. But, Michael, you've got to wonder, what would cause Rocky Maivia to do this? Coming back off of the knee injury, it could have been a fresh start. But the fans never respected Rocky Maivia. Maybe that was the cause. We'll find out, I'm sure, in the weeks to come. But a guy can only read signs in the crowd that say, die, Rocky, die, for so long before it changes him.
As we see Skull and 8-Ball head to the ring now on the Harleys from the Disciples of Apocalypse. Kevin, of course, Rocky won the Intercontinental Championship. And from what I understand, there was a lot of resentment since he was a rookie back in the locker room area and even in the crowd. that he won at such a tender young age.
Well, absolutely. They said, you know, too young to get a push. What's the story? Why is he getting the title? There's other guys that are more deserving. And that caused a lot of resentment in the locker room, as you say, and in the crowd. Rocky always did things by the book. Now I think he's going to do things his way. And his way, unfortunately, I think for him, is joining the Nation of Domination. As Ahmed Johnson saw, that's no way to go. And Ahmed Johnson recovering once again, the knee re-aggravated by the savage attack caused by his former brethren there in the Nation of Domination. This is going to be a wild tag team contest, though, here with 8-Ball and Skull.
D'Lo Brown now hooking up with 8-Ball.
How can you tell which is which?
Well, 8-Ball, I guess, a little heavier, someone told me, from what I understand, but it's really hard to tell. They're identical twins. As D'Lo Brown now whips 8-Ball into the ropes, big elbow. I'll tell you what, Kevin, Rocky will be successful in the Nation as long as he understands that Farouk is the leader of that group. Also the leader of the Disciples of Apocalypse, Crush. You know, Farouk and Crush will be involved with the leader of Los Pericuas, Savio Vega, in an unbelievable triple threat match at Ground Zero.
Oh, yeah, Louisville street fight, folks, right there at the Louisville Gardens on Sunday, September 7th. It's going to be, as JR says, an old-fashioned slobber knocker, and it's going to be great. Former members of the original Nation are going to be hooking it up in the triple threat rules match, but it's going to be a Louisville street fight. Anything goes at Ground Zero.
Kama goes well over 300 pounds. He's about 6'8". He's the powerhouse from the Nation. Misses with a big right hand. 8-Ball now off the ropes. Oh, double clothesline for both men. Quickly, both men get up. Kama now with a big boot to the midsection. Backs 8-Ball into the ropes. Nice reversal. Kama off the ropes this time. Oh, big boot underneath the chin. Kama in trouble.
What is 8-Ball and Skull really are identical. It's going to be tough for the referee to keep track of who's who in there.
And here we will see now for the first time Skull in the ring against Kama Mustafa.
Two great tag team matchups coming this week on Raw. Not only will we see the Legion of Doom take on Owen Hart and the British Bulldog, but what about the tag team matchup everybody all over the world is talking about? The Undertaker teams with Mankind to take on the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels and Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Kind of wonder what's going on with Ravishing Rick Rude.
Raw is war. And what about this past week on Raw? We saw that unbelievable matchup with Shawn Michaels and Mankind. Shawn Michaels debuting his insurance policy, Ravishing Rick Rude. Also in Shawn Michaels' corner, Hunter Hearst Helmsley in China. What is going on there?
Maybe it's a group coverage plan. You know what I mean? A lot of people talking about the clique of HBK possibly being reformed. I don't know about that one, though.
Cover now. There's two before D'Lo kicks out. This is 8-Ball now in the ring working on D'Lo Brown. And what about The Undertaker? He headed down to the ring this past week on Raw to confront Shawn Michaels, and all of a sudden, Paul Bearer showed up on the Titantron. Ooh! The clothesline from behind. 8-Ball now outside the ring, and Kama Mustafa will go to work on 8-Ball.
And then
Paul Bearer shows up in the Titantron. There's fire, there's red lights, and Paul Bearer tells The Undertaker, that Kane is coming.
And a spooked look in the eye of The Undertaker like I've never seen before. And what about The Undertaker teaming with Mankind? Who'd have thought? 3 months ago, these two were in each other's throats throwing fire at one another. Now they're going to be tag team partners.
It's going to be unbelievable this week when Raw is war in Atlantic City, New Jersey. D'Lo now slamming 8-Ball to the canvas. Comes across with a big elbow across the sternum. Here's a cover, two before a kick out by 8-Ball from Disciples of Apocalypse. Here's D'Lo again, could be the most underrated wrestler here in the World Wrestling Federation. Tags in Kama Mustafa, the powerhouse from the Nation of Domination, 300 plus pounds, 6'7", as D'Lo Brown gets a couple extra shots in before leaving the ring. He needs to make a tag here.
Are you sure that's 8-Ball?
Yeah, I'm sure that's 8-Ball. I think it's 8-Ball. Oh, whatever. Let's just call him DOA. DOA in trouble after the double elbow that time. D'Lo covers. There's two. 8-Ball kicks out.
Yeah, he's the one on the receiving end from a lot of punishment. D'Lo Brown and Kama Mustafa moving very effectively. Although Farouk not out here at ringside, you know his leadership is really honing the skills of these two and combining a very devastating force.
Nice body slam by Kama Mustafa. To go up now into the second rope. Kama from this high up with all his power. Oh! 8-Ball moved. I'll tell you what, if Kama connected on that, it would have been all over. But now Kama's in trouble.
Both men needing to make a tag. We'll see. I guess that is 8-Ball in there. Skull on the outside. Tag is made. Here we go.
Skull wants D'Lo Brown. Oh, man, what a power move. D'Lo knocked down in the middle of the ring, and here we go, off the ropes now. Skull with a big back body drop.
What elevation.
Here comes Kama, clothesline, another clothesline. The Nation in trouble, body slam by Skull. Body slam by D'Lo Brown, unbelievable action. Oh, big right hand, a clothesline knocks him out of the ring.
The competitive atmosphere in the World Wrestling Federation bringing the most out of all these great superstars.
Smart move by Kama Mustafa.
Certainly was. As Skull took a hard tumble out to the floor.
Uh-oh, here comes 8-Ball now.
Wait a second, looks like D'Lo got in just before the count. Let's go to the official decision here.
As a result of a count-out, the new Nation of Domination!
What a smart move. I'll tell you what, D'Lo Brown, in my opinion, probably the most underrated superstar in the World Wrestling Federation today.
Well, he certainly will be gaining prominence in the high-profile organization, the Nation of Domination, winners by countout. But obviously, Michael, nothing settled. In the factional war between the Nation of Domination, the Disciples of Apocalypse, don't forget about Los Barrancos, the Heart Foundation, so many more.
Truth Commission, got to throw the Truth Commission in there. Kevin, that's uncalled for. There are actually some Vader fans out here in the audience. Vader actually has a few fans out there, believe it or not. He heads down the runway now to the ring for this matchup.
Well, we got a lot to talk about in this upcoming battle. And Vader and Hunter Hearst Helmsley, these two men don't like each other, folks. And they're going to settle the score right here on Shotgun.
Tell you what, this feud has been going on for months now. Going to be interesting to see what happens outside the ring with China and Paul Bearer.
We'll tell you all about what's happening in the locker room as well. These two guys really hate each other. Shotgun continues, folks.
Shotgun, Michael Cole, and Kevin Kelly. You see Triple H and his bodyguard, China. What a physical matchup between Shawn and Mankind this past week on Raw.
It certainly was. Reliving the memory of In Your House Mind Games from 96. Those two men were all over the place. Tables and chairs were flying, and of course, the insurance policy apparently cashed in by Shawn Michaels. But Hunter Hearst Helmsley and China surprised everybody with their appearance at ringside. Well, kind of, sort of. It was Ravishing Rick Rude, or was it Hunter? We're not really sure.
And this week on Raw, what a tag team matchup. That man, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, will team up with the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, to take on The Undertaker and Mankind. Unbelievable action on Raw this week. There you see him, the 1997 King of the Ring, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, along with his 200-pound bodyguard, China, set to hook up with the man they call Vader in a feud that's been a simmering here for the past couple of weeks. A couple of weeks ago, Vader and Triple H were supposed to hook up, but Mankind, dressed in a cameraman's outfit, interfered. It hit Hunter Hearst Helmsley over the back of the head with a camera. And then the following week, they were supposed to hook up again. They actually did get it on for a couple of minutes. But outside the ring, China delivered a dropkick to Paul Bearer, virtually ending that matchup. There you see now the bodyguard for Triple H, China, as this matchup gets underway. Here we go now, Vader locking up with Hunter Hearst Helmsley. The Mastodon tossing the 1997 King of the Ring into the corner, and Hunter slips out of the ring. What about Paul Bearer outside the ring? You remember when these two met a couple of weeks ago on Raw? China delivered that drop kick to Paul Bearer outside the ring?
I remember the week before. Remember when Mankind came in dressed as the cameraman and got all over Hunter Hearst Helmsley? I understand that Vader and Hunter almost came to blows in the locker room after that conflict. And this is a wound that has been opened courtesy of Hunter's big mouth. And I've got a feeling that Vader's going to look to shut it here on Shotgun.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley slapping Vader, and then he hightails it out of the ring. Vader, of course, a great pro football player. He actually went to the Super Bowl back in 1979 with the Los Angeles Rams. I also understand he was a great college football star in Colorado.
Certainly was. He was all-conference in three different offensive line positions in the same year, Michael. And research is being done right now to see if any other player in NCAA history has ever done that. Certainly no one in Big 8 history has done that. Vader is also up for nomination for the Big 8 Hall of Fame and the NCAA College Football Hall of Fame.
Vader, of course, handing Ken Shamrock his first loss here in the World Wrestling Federation, albeit with the help of the British Bulldog, as he hammers away now at the former Intercontinental Champ, Hunter Hearst Helmsley. We were talking about Rocky Maivia a little bit earlier in the program. Hunter, of course, lost his title to Rocky earlier this year.
Certainly was, but I think if Hunter Hearst Helmsley...
Oh, what a move!
If he finds a way to get through Vader, if he's got himself aligned with his buddy Shawn Michaels, everybody talking about HBK's click once again, Shawn, Hunter, China, whoever else you want to throw in there, if you want to include Rick Rude, we'll have to wait and see what happens on that deal, but it could be very good for Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Vader off the ropes. Look at that! What a power move by Hunter, tossing Vader into the ropes. Vader now. Oh, sunset flip. Can Hunter turn him over?
Uh-oh.
No, he can't, but Vader misses with a splash. Hunter Hearst Helmsley getting out of the way. Triple H now in control. Oh, big clothesline. Vader outside the ring. That's familiar to Vader. He lost to the Patriot Del Wilkes in recent weeks in similar fashion, and the Patriot's been on a roll.
Certainly was. Remember last week in the Battle Royal, the Patriot eliminated Vader, cost Vader the win in the Battle Royal, and those two superstars are going to lock up. Patriot with all the momentum right now.
I cannot wait for September 7th, Ground Zero in Louisville, as you see Hunter now with a big clothesline on Vader. When the Patriot locks up with the Hitman, Bret Hart, the WWF Championship on the line. It's going to be great action in Louisville.
Vader's in a lot of trouble. Paul Bearer is beside himself, and that's a big place to be beside.
Triple H is in control. Stay with us. That got Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. Triple H in control. Big body slam.
Did you see Helmsley just scoop up 458? I think China's really been working him out in the weight room.
Here's a cover now. Hooks the leg. There's two. Vader kicks out after two. Speaking of China, you know, she deadlifts in the mid-400 range. She could probably deadlift Vader.
Well, she'd have to work up to be able to pick up Paul Bearer, but that might be a goal for her. These two superstars have really been hooking it up here on Shotgun, Michael.
Oh, Vader into the corner. Here comes Triple H, catches a boot from the man they call Vader, the Mastodon from Colorado. Big clothesline. This week on Raw, both men will be involved. Vader takes on the Patriot. Triple H teaming with Heartbreak Kid against Undertaker and Mankind. Here's a cover now. Two, almost three. Triple H somehow manages to get his shoulder up.
Incredible agility from Vader, 458 pounds. Let's take a look at the double feature. I don't know how Helmsley escaped, but he did. And of course, Michael, a lot of speculation about Hunter Hearst Helmsley teaming with the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels this Monday on Raw against The Undertaker and Mankind.
You see Vader now working on that left arm of Hunter Hearst Helmsley as Paul Bearer looks on. Look, a concern on his face. Hunter trying to reach the ropes. And folks, the UK Superstar line is up and running. 0891-299-888. The maximum cost of a call, £3. Calls cost 50p a minute regardless of the time of the call. And if you're under 18 years of age, parental permission is required before calling. Referee Tim White calling for the break as Triple H now reaches to the ropes. Vader backs him into the corner. Here he goes, going to work on Triple H. You see the many fans of the World Wrestling Federation. Little Vader fan there. Vader knocking Triple H to the canvas. Tim White telling him to open those fists up. Vader backing Hunter Hearst Helmsley into the corner. Whips him across the ring. Oh, my! Hunter, look at him. La La Land. Center of the ring. He's in trouble. Vader looks like he's going to set him up now. Oh, another splash.
That'll
two.
This one's over.
How did he get his shoulder up?
I don't believe it. I do not believe it. Somehow Helmsley stuck a shoulder out at two and a whole bunch.
Look at China. New hairdo this week.
She's staring right across at Paul Bearer. Seemed like she was looking right through the action in the ring to stare across at the bulbous funeral director.
Oh, nice belly to belly that time. Vader tossing Hunter Hearst Helmsley like a rag doll across the ring. Triple H, look at his face. He doesn't know where he is.
He's trying to get his bearings right now. He's trying to locate himself in the ring. Disoriented, confused, and dazed, Vader has pounded away on Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Uh-oh, Paul Bearer now sneaking up to the ring apron. There's China. China yelling at referee Tim White saying, look out for Paul Bearer. Paul Bearer is now interfered in this matchup as China, a look of disgust, jumps down off the ring. Vader now in control thanks to Paul Bearer. What's he going to do? Lifts him up. Body slam. Vader in control. Vader now heading up to the ropes. Looks like we're going to have the Vader bomb here.
Looks like we could have the China bomb on Paul Bearer.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. China. She's in the ring now. Oh, no. Referee Tim White calling for the bell. It looks like China will be disqualified after interfering in this matchup. She and Hunter Hearst Helmsley are going to hightail it to the locker room. Paul Bearer now up on the apron. This thing's over with.
The winner of this bout, as a result of a disqualification, the man they call Vader.
What a win for the man they call Vader. Winner by disqualification. Don't forget Raw this week. What a show. The Undertaker and Mankind take on the Heartbreak Kid and Triple H. You'll see Vader take on the Patriot and the Legion of Doom beat Owen Hart and the British Bulldog. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole. Thanks for joining us, everybody, on Shotgun. Bulldog, and here you'll see Tiger Ali Singh against Dan Ackerman. We also have a very special new feature in Shotgun this week.
Is that the Michael Cole report?
No, it's actually Matt Classic.
I thought we went and visited your house and talked to your wife and got the real story.
Got the real story on Michael Cole. It's called Matt Classic. We'll take you back to May 17, 1992. Sheffield, England, the British Bulldog will be in action. What can you tell us about this superstar, Tiger Ali Singh?
Tell you what, Tiger Ali Singh, certainly a star in the making. On his way, there's his father, the legendary Tiger Jeet Singh, second-generation star Tiger Ali Singh, born in Toronto, Canada, but represents many different cultures. His father, a native of India, came over to Canada as a young man, competed in strongman contests. He entered Canada, Michael, with $6 in his pocket. He is a world-renowned star. In fact, he has assembled a worldwide corporation. This man is a millionaire many times over, and now he is handling the career of his son. He is not going it alone, though. He has hired the Iron Sheik, as we just saw in the ring, to kind of manage his career with the training and with the preparation for each match.
Tiger Ali Singh really made a bang in the World Wrestling Federation. Spring of this year, he won the prestigious Kuwaiti Cup, which was won in 1996 by Ahmed Johnson. And, well, listen up. There's Tiger Jeet Singh introducing his son, Tiger Ali Singh, to this crowd here this week. What's he saying?
My son, Tiger Ali Singh, that WWF's going to
Well, a lot of our fans watching this broadcast do know what Mr. Singh is saying. I'm not privy to his native language, though. I had a brief conversation with Tiger Jeet Singh. I don't care where the Sheik is from. Nobody understands him.
The Iron Sheik, the former WWF champion.
You people, shut up! Don't say USA!
Okay, now that we understand.
You people, shut up, what he said.
It's not very nice. I don't know if Tiger Ali Singh needs all of this before a matchup. He needs to get in there. He needs time in the ring. That's what's going to solidify his greatness. He comes in. He's a physical specimen, to say the least. He's 6'5", 283 pounds, Michael. And I'll tell you what, all this young man needs is time. He will achieve greatness.
He's a great athlete. He recruited to play basketball at Notre Dame and other colleges. I also understand he can dunk a basketball.
Certainly can with ease. Dan Ackerman just got dunked right there in the corner.
Tiger Ali Singh now from Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Calls himself an Indo-Canadian. Oh, big boot to the abdomen. Now a right hand to the side of the head.
Obviously, the Sheik and Jeet Singh have really taught him to be aggressive.
Let's see how Tiger's going to do in this matchup. We'll see. Shotgun continues. Cole and Kevin Kelly, Tiger Ali Singh. Firmly in control now of Dan Ackerman. Whoa, what a right hand, and Ackerman in trouble. What do you know about Dan Ackerman?
I feel sorry for Dan. I know Dan quite well. He's a great athlete, but he is just being overrun here by Tiger Ali Singh. This young man came into the World Wrestling Federation, big smile on his face, happy to be here. But you see the sneer, and you see the fact he's very,
cover
very
now.
Vicious.
There's two, but he didn't want to finish Ackerman there. Tiger wants to inflict a little more punishment. There's his father, the legendary Tiger Jeet Singh. Tiger Ali Singh says his two heroes in life, his dad and also Bret Hart.
Absolutely.
Misses with a right hand. A little slow that time, and Ackerman tries to catch it with a clothesline. Now a drop kick. It's like hitting a brick wall. Ackerman again this time misses with a drop kick.
I don't think Ackerman can dunk a basketball.
Tiger Ali Singh swatting him away like a fly. There's the Iron Sheik now shouting instructions to Tiger Ali Singh. Big elbow across the sternum. Ackerman in trouble. He's been in trouble since the beginning of this matchup.
Despite not having competed in the World Wrestling Federation until recently, Tiger Ali Singh began his career in the Far East, competing in Japan and the Philippines and Singapore, and in a lot of different styles of wrestling. Now in the American catch-as-catch-can style, he has been very effective so far in the World Wrestling Federation.
Tiger Ali Singh up to the top rope. Look out, Ackerman in trouble. There's the Bulldog. Finishing move for Tiger Ali Singh. Cover up now. There's two and three. It's over. Tiger Ali Singh victorious on Shotgun.
Very impressive young man. Certainly has a bright future ahead of him. I know he is going to be in England at the Birmingham NEC on September the 20th, part of One Night Only.
Now we're going to have the privilege to hear from Tiger Ali Singh.
Now him, I understand.
Hope he treats the microphone a little bit better this week than he did last time we saw him on Shotgun.
He's hearing it from these fans in the United States.
Canadian! Show me respect and shut up!
Not going to get it that way.
He could ask Rocky Balboa about that.
I make a promise to all my fans in Canada and all my fans around the world. Every American wrestler who faces me will fall one by one.
Got a lot of great action coming. Still to come here on Shotgun. Folks, right now, let's go to Todd Pettengill with a special Ground Zero One Night Only report. Here we go.
Hi, I'm Todd Pettengill with a WWF update. By now, most of you have heard about the situation with Stone Cold Steve Austin. He had indicated that he wants to wrestle, but is currently not being allowed to do so. His fate rests in the hands of WWF officials. Now, while alternative plans are being made for the fatal four-way matchup at WWF Ground Zero in your house on Sunday, the 7th of September, please know that if he is unable to participate, Austin will be forced to forfeit the tag team title. On a happier note, I've got some news for you fans in Birmingham. The Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels will be appearing at Victoria Square in the Birmingham City Center on Monday, September the 1st at 1:30 p.m. It's open to the public, and word has it that the Heartbreak Kid has a special message for his UK fans. Speaking of Birmingham, we obviously have potential changes to report regarding the event at the NEC on September the 20th. Contingency plans are in place, and should the card change due to Austin's injury, here it is. In a title rematch from SummerSlam, Bret the Hitman Hart and the man from the dark side, The Undertaker, will collide. Folks, you know the story from SummerSlam. The Undertaker did not think he got a fair shake from referee Shawn Michaels. And this may be his last chance for revenge and the WWF title. Now, speaking of Shawn Michaels, the UK's own British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, will take on the Heartbreak Kid for the WWF European Championship. The Bulldog is arguably the strongest man in the World Wrestling Federation today. But will he be able to take care of business when he collides against the World Wrestling Federation's most flamboyant superstar? And don't forget that Shawn Michaels now has an insurance policy in the form of his new associate and former WWF Intercontinental Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude. Will he get involved in the action? Well, these questions will all be answered September the 20th at the NEC in Birmingham. Another matchup on the card features two-time Slammy Award winner Owen Hart against the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock. We know the Hart Foundation will be watching this battle, and that means Shamrock better be watching his back. The American Blue Blood, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, squares off against that hip cat Dude Love, and you've got to believe China won't be far from the action. In tag competition, you've got the Legion of Doom taking on the Hog Farmers. It's going to be quite a night, September 20th, from the World Wrestling Federation.
Still to come on Shotgun, tag team action is Goldust and
Jude Love take on Owen Hart and the British Bulldog.
Still to come here on Shotgun, some great tag team action as Jude Love and Goldust square off against Owen Hart and the British Bulldog. Stay with us. Shotgun continues.
The WWF presents the Slam of the Week.
Wait a minute. There's Rocky Maivia. There's The Rock. Great to see The Rock back. What's he doing in the ring?
Check it on the referee, make sure he's okay.
Watch Rocky Maivia come from the crowd to help the official, we think.
While Chains had Farouk covered.
And then, look at this. Oh, I think we have just seen a new member of the nation. I can't believe this.
That was the WWF Slam of the Week.
The Shotgun, Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. Here he comes, Flash Funk from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, set to lock it up with Rocky Maivia. Let's hear from Rocky and why he joined the nation.
Some very emotional, very heartfelt comments from Rocky Maivia. Quite inflammatory, but very honest. According to Rocky Maivia, well, we're getting set to see Rocky in action. The first time since he has joined the nation. Take a look, Michael, on the stage. All of the members of the Nation of Domination joining in a show of support for the newest member, Rocky Maivia. You know, after Rocky finished his comments this past week on Raw, all of a sudden the Disciples of Apocalypse pop up on the Titantron, challenged him to a brawl. In fact, let's take a look at exactly what happened, Michael. Chased him on foot, but I understand, Michael, that the Los Barriguas are still in possession of the Disciples' bikes.
And I understand they have no intentions of returning them either. Now, Kevin, you know Rocky well. I had the opportunity to talk with him before the matchup. He says this is not about racism. This is all about the fans. Rocky Maivia was extremely upset with the way the fans treated him after he won the Intercontinental Championship, the youngest Intercontinental Champion ever at 24 years old. Rocky said there were signs being held up in the audience, die, Rocky, die. There was the familiar chant of Rocky, well, you know. And Rocky really didn't take too kindly to that criticism. He says this is all about the fans, not about racism, the reason that he joined Farouk, Kama, and D'Lo in the nation. You can hear the fans now letting Rocky know what they think about it.
And you know what? It's unwarranted. It's wrong, because this young man is a tremendously gifted athlete. You are looking, in my opinion, at a future World Wrestling Federation champion.
He's already won the Intercontinental Championship.
And absolutely, there's nothing that's going to stop him. For whatever reason, the fans, I don't know, maybe they felt like he was handed things on a silver platter. The young man has a tremendous lineage. We know he's a third-generational superstar, but come on. I mean, you cannot blame this young man for his feelings towards the fans. I don't agree with his joining of the Nation of Domination. I think that's like making a deal with the devil. But I think Rocky perhaps was caught at an emotional crossroad, not sure whether he could go back to the fans, and I think Farouk took advantage of that situation.
Speaking of the Nation of Domination, the three original members of the nation, Savio Vega, Crush, and of course Farouk, will meet on September 7th at WWF Ground Zero in your house at the sold-out Louisville Garden in a triple threat match to settle that feud, possibly for good.
I can tell you what, that is going to be a physical confrontation. You got to wonder, will the Los Barriguas be riding into Louisville on top of the bikes of the DOA? Who knows what they're going to do?
It's going to be interesting to see if Commissioner Slaughter is going to allow the rest of the members of all these factions to be around ringside. Going to be unbelievable.
And you know what? I give a pat on the back to Commissioner Slaughter. He has had a hard job, but I tell you what, he has done about as good as you can, trying to keep the action away from, you know, not letting extra people be around the ringside area.
And are these folks beginning to listen to Commissioner Slaughter? Look at the rest of the nation. They're up on the ramp. They're not around ringside.
Well, they know if they did make a move towards ringside, Slaughter would be down there.
Wow. Whoa, man. What a right hand by Rocky Maivia. You're going to want to stay tuned to the rest of this program. We're going to have the latest information on Stone Cold Steve Austin's injury. Understand, Kevin, he met with a spinal specialist, a Dr. Joseph Torg, in Philadelphia this week.
Certainly is, and it's a good news, bad news situation.
You know what I find interesting? Rocky Maivia was a defensive lineman for the University of Miami. He won a national championship at that school. Farouk, of course, of the Nation of Domination, was a superstar at Florida State, Miami's rival.
Yeah, my alma mater and the hated rival of Miami.
Rocky with a cover before Flash pops that shoulder up after two. As you mentioned, the first ever third generation superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation, Rocky Maivia.
lifts Flash Funk in the air with ease and slams into the canvas.
And I'll tell you what, Flash has some momentum going for him now coming into this matchup, just defeating Brian Christopher this past week on Raw.
Here's the cover, two before Flash Funk gets his shoulder up. This past week on Raw, Flash Funk actually beat Brian Pillman, forcing him to wrestle again and address this past week.
Well, yeah, we'll see. We'll see Goldust in a little while, so we'll talk all about Brian Pillman. But once again, Brian Pillman's going to have to find a way to win a match to get out of the dress on Raw.
Rocky Maivia now pounding away at the head of Flash Funk. Rocky Maivia, a very smart young man. He was a double major at the University of Miami. Sweet heel kick by Flash Funk. Flash Funk now with a cover on Rocky Maivia. There's two before Rocky gets that shoulder up, and Flash says he's ready to do some high-flying maneuvers. Lifts Rocky Maivia up now. Here's the chop across the chest. Rocky stunned. Take a look at what happened here, Kevin.
Great counter move there. That's how explosive Flash Funk is. You see explosion once again in the corner. And now going up top is Flash Funk.
Off the top rope. Oh, a cross body. He might have got him there. There's two. Rocky kicks out.
Didn't hook the leg. That could have cost him. Flash, though, getting it going.
Flash Funk says he's ready to go off the ropes now. Oh, but Rocky catches him. Here we go. You're an Andy suplex. That's going to be it. Here's the cover. Hooks the leg. Two and three. Rocky Maivia victorious in his first match as a member of the Nation of Domination.
The Unified Nation, Farouk and D'Lo Brown all on the stage watching the newest member, Rocky Maivia. The salute is raised. A victory for Rocky here on Shotgun.
Rocky Maivia victorious. A member of the Nation of Domination. Let's take a look at what happened here.
Well, it certainly was a back-and-forth match. But as you see, Flash had the momentum. Rocky cuts him right off the Uranagi, plants him, hooks the leg, and a three count is told.
Rocky Maivia yelling at the fans. Of course, he said it was because of the fans that he went to the Nation of Domination.
How would you like it if you saw a sign that said, "Die, Michael Cole, die," everywhere you went?
I would be affected, just like Rocky Maivia is.
Absolutely.
You got to understand a little bit of where Rocky Maivia is going. Was joining the Nation of Domination the right thing to do? I'm not quite sure.
Time will tell.
Well, we've been telling you all throughout the show that Stone Cold visited a doctor this past week in Philadelphia. My colleague Kevin Kelly now with more on Stone Cold Steve Austin's injury.
Up next on Shotgun, we will hear from the World Wrestling Federation champion, Bret Hart.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please welcome the World Wrestling Federation champion from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, Bret Hitman Hart.
Here he comes, the Hitman, the World Wrestling Federation champion, five-time WWF Federation champion, getting ready for a huge matchup. As you can see, the fans here in America do not like Bret Hart. WWF Ground Zero in your house, Sunday, September 7th. We understand they sold out Louisville Gardens in Louisville, Kentucky. 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. Bret Hart will defend the World Wrestling Federation Championship against the Patriot, Dale Wills. Don't forget, the Patriot already holds a victory over Bret Hart before Bret won the championship. On Raw a couple of weeks ago, he beat Bret in the center of the ring. 1, 2, 3. It's going to be interesting to hear what Bret has to tell JR this week about that matchup and also about the incident on Raw this past week with Vader.
Bret, on Sunday, September the 7th, on pay-per-view from the sold-out Louisville Gardens, you will be faced with the challenge of the Patriot, Dale Wilkes. I want to talk about that. I'd like for you to address that situation. I know you've had some recent problems with Vader, but perhaps on a more pleasant note, going to be headed back to the United Kingdom as well on September 20th. A very busy and ambitious schedule for the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Well, at least they don't spit on you and throw stuff at you and call you names for the simple reason all you do is come out here week after week after week and tell the truth. I can't wait to go back to the United Kingdom and see all my fans over in England, because I know that they still know me and respect me for being a hero around the world, unlike the American wrestling fans. But the American wrestling fans are gonna get just what they deserve, because the Patriot, the guy that wants to preach and practice American values, none of which I've seen come lately, but you're gonna find out at Ground Zero that the Patriot is just one American hero that just isn't gonna cut it. Now, I don't know what Big Vader's problem is, but I want to make something real clear right here, right now, that if that big tub of goo's got some kind of a problem with the World Wrestling Federation champion, myself, I would be happy to settle any differences this Friday's main event. Vader, come and get it.
Wow.
Because the way I see it, you're just another name on a list of Americans that I'm flushing down the toilet, and I just hope that, Vader, that you don't plug the bowl up.
Ooh, very distasteful comments from the World Wrestling Federation champion.
I just want to say that I am truly the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be, whether the American wrestling fans like it or not.
If it wasn't for his goon squad, Brett wouldn't have gotten the best of Vader.
But there is no denying that he is perhaps the greatest champion the World Wrestling Federation has.
Gotta agree with you there.
Up next, tag team action with the Hart Foundation. Brett's little brother Owen and his brother-in-law, the British Bulldog, take on the bizarre one, Goldust, along with a unique partner,
the hippest cat in the land.
Ow! Have mercy! There they are, the first couple of the World Wrestling Federation.
On the beach of Atlantic City. That's what it's all about, Michael. Quality time with the family.
It really is. That's Dustin and Terry Reynolds in Dakota, not Goldust and Marlena there. Truly a lovely family.
One, two, three.
Well, Dakota got the best of Daddy there on that one.
Oh.
Now time to go to work, though. Goldust and Marlena getting set for tag team action. But you know, Michael, things may not be as rosy as they appear for Goldust and Marlena, for Dustin and Terry.
What a tag team matchup. Goldust partner.
Chick magnet right there.
Unbelievable. The women scream for him whenever he walks into an arena.
Well, who could blame him? Take a look.
I'll tell you what, dude love heading to the ring.
He's the hippest cat in the land, Daddy-O.
Summer of love here in the World Wrestling Federation. You know there's going to be an auction underway here in about a month or so to commemorate the Summer of Love. Some of the things they're auctioning off, the house where the Grateful Dead live, a love letter from Joni Mitchell. They could even auction off that dude love hat.
I think that might be the hottest item of all. Check it out.
Dude Love doing a dance in the ring with Goldust. But this team will have its hands full this week here on Shotgun. They're going to be taking on the former WWF Tag Team Champion.
Come on, Howard, do your job. Like a magic eight ball.
This team here, a quarter of the teams will be participating in the fatal four-way at WWF Round Zero in your house. It is a four-team elimination tournament for the Tag Team Championship. Also, the Godwins, the Legion of Doom, and Dude Love and his partner Stone Cold Steve Austin, the current champions. We understand, Kevin, Stone Cold is planning on being in Louisville.
Absolutely. Doctor's advice would be for Stone Cold to not attend in Louisville, but based on what the doctors have said, what Stone Cold says, I got a feeling Austin's going to be there.
Whether or not WWF officials allow Steve Austin to wrestle at Ground Zero is a different story. We'll have more on that in the weeks to come. Meanwhile, UK, listen up. Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid, will be appearing Monday, September 1st at 1:30 p.m. at Victoria Square at the Birmingham City Center. It is open to the public. We hear that Shawn has a special message for all the UK fans. And, of course, he's going to talk about that big event, September 20th, the Birmingham NEC. The Heartbreak Kid will be in action.
back to ground zero. WWF ground zero in your house. Louisville, Kentucky, Sunday, September 7th. It's sold out at the Louisville Gardens. In addition to the WWF title, Bret Hart versus the Patriot, Shawn Michaels will be in action for the first time ever against The Undertaker. A fatal four-way matchup, a triple threat matchup, and also Brian Pillman and Goldust in a match. Some very interesting stipulations.
With Dude Love with the standing side headlock on Owen Hart, we heard this past week on Raw. Brian Pillman said, if he loses in this match to Goldust, he'll leave the World Wrestling Federation forever. But if Goldust loses, Brian Pillman gets Marlena's professional services and managerial skills. Who knows what it entails? But he'll have Marlena for 30 days. Now, Goldust didn't want to accept, but Marlena, for whatever reason, accepted the challenge. Now, Brian Pillman made some very inflammatory comments I am not going to repeat, an accusation, if you will. But suffice to say, Goldust and Marlena, things are a little unsettled at the Runnels house right now.
Really are. Goldust, as you mentioned, did not want to accept that matchup, Marlena said.
You were right there. I mean, was there some, there was some real tension up there.
And what happened was, what we didn't see was when they left the runway and actually went back in the locker room, the argument between Goldust and Marlena continued.
Wow.
It's going to be interesting to see what happens over the next couple of weeks. Hopefully we'll get an update on this situation.
And take a look now, Dude Love.
Oh, looks like BK.
Yeah, a little sweet kid music. That heart on his chest may not be an accident.
Look out, Owen. Oh, big boot to the midsection. Nice takedown by Dude Love. Here's a cover. Two. Owen kicks out.
Dude Love, no small man. We know him as Mankind. We know him as Dude Love. Mom knows him as Mick Foley's. Right around the 300-pound mark. He's quite a load in the ring.
Owen Hart now. Trying to get out of this little... There we go. Nice reversal by Owen Hart. Dude Love trying to get some momentum. He's prancing around the ring. Here's Owen, though, with the athleticism. Dude Love with a chop now into the neck of Owen Hart. Calls for the later Goldust.
Fighting. Remember that song, Carl Douglas?
That's what he looks like out there as we now see the bizarre one. Goldust, the two-time Intercontinental Champion, heading into the ring. Nice takedown to Owen Hart. Here's a quick cover now by Goldust. Two before Owen kicks out.
Owen Hart has been very focused lately ever since he showed compassion in his own words at SummerSlam, cost him the Intercontinental title. And now the Bulldog comes in off the tag, the single leg takedown. Bulldog going back to basics, turns it over, single leg Boston Crab. As Michael told you earlier on, Bulldog's opponent, September 20th, Shawn Michaels, is going to be heading to the UK on Monday, September the 1st. A special appearance at Victoria Square at Birmingham City Center at 1:30 p.m. It's open to the public, and we understand that Shawn has a special message at that time for the fans in the UK. Should be very interesting.
Goldust now working on the British Bulldog. Nice takedown. There's a big right hand across the face of Davey Boy Smith.
So this is the type of match that's suited for the Bulldog and Owen. They have an opportunity here to really exert themselves as an organized team. I don't think Goldust and Dude have ever teamed before, but they're certainly moving very effectively.
Goldust working now on the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, and these fans this week here on Shotgun really enjoying this action. Owen and the Bulldog against Goldust and Dude Love. Here we go now. Dude Love heading into the ring off the tag from Goldust. Big boot now to the midsection of the British Bulldog. British Bulldog, of course, involved in that huge event, September 20th, one night only at the Birmingham NEC over in the United Kingdom. That's going to be a great night.
Defending the European title against the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, and Manchester's favorite son going back home.
Dude Love. Oh! Spinning heel kick by Owen Hart. He caught Dude up underneath the chin. Owen now looks for the tag, and now he gets it from the British Bulldog.
I'm surprised Owen didn't go for the cover. Remember last week on Shotgun, that spinning heel kick defeated Goldust. You know Goldust looking for revenge on this one. And perhaps Owen and the Bulldog made a mistake in not covering Dude Love right there.
Dude Love now working with the British Bulldog into the corner. Dude Love face first into the canvas.
The Bulldog is so strong, Michael.
Perhaps, pound for pound, the strongest in the World Wrestling Federation today.
Tell you what, Owen Hart and the Bulldog are going to be even some real powerhouses in that fatal four-way. We know Steve Austin and Dude Love set to defend the tag team titles, but joining them in that matchup will be the Legion of Doom, the Godwins, and of course Owen Hart and the British Bulldog. But what about Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker for the first time ever? What an intense battle that's going to be. But what about Rick Rude? Where does his allegiance lie?
We heard about Rick Rude. We heard from, I should say, Rick Rude this past week on Raw. Rick says he's not working for anybody. If you pay him, he will work for anyone in the World Wrestling Federation. He shows allegiance to no one.
that you better make sure your premiums are paid up, Michael.
Oh, Owen, across the sternum, we have more when Shotgun continues.
UK, this is the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
We're the Headbangers. I'm Thrasher.
This is Mosh.
Hey, UK, I'm Rocky Maivia.
It's all the nonstop excitement
of your favorite superstars.
Us.
In action every week, right here on Sky.
Welcome back to Shotgun. Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly, the British Bulldog, working on Dude Love. What a show on Raw this week. The main event. Vader and the champion, Bret Hart.
I think back not too long ago, Vader scored the upset win over Bret the Hitman Hart on Raw. Lightning could strike twice. It seems that Vader now may have had a renaissance, a little bit of patriotism stirred courtesy of the Patriot. He did not appreciate seeing Bret Hart lay the Canadian flag over the top of the fallen Patriot.
Oh, speaking of falling, the British Bulldog falling to the canvas. He's in trouble. Dude Love now looking to gain some momentum from this capacity crowd here. Trying to head to the corner and tag his partner Goldust. Davey Boy Smith needs to get to Owen Hart.
I see some worried looks on some Dude groupies. Some of the ladies around ringside.
Here comes Duty, tag Goldust. Here comes Goldust. Big clothesline. Takes out Owen Hart. Big right hand. British Bulldog in trouble. That's Owen into the ropes now.
Goldust with a chance for revenge here. Remember, Owen Hart came out on top last week thanks to Brian Pillman.
Oh, big right hand. Owen in trouble now in the middle of the ring. Big right hand now. The British Bulldog on the apron. Goldust in control.
Here we go. Curtain call.
This could be it. The Bulldog though with the save. And Dude Love in the ring. All four men now in the ring.
Referee Tim Wyatt.
Oh, look out.
Brian
What's
Pillman.
This?
Keep him away from Marlena. Brian Pillman sneaking in from the outside.
Oh, Bulldog. This should end it. Goldust could cover Owen here.
Get Pillman off the apron.
What's
Get him
he
out
doing?
Of here.
Pillman doing?
Where's Commissioner Ooh, Slaughter?
This with the right hand. Pillman, though, distracting Goldust. Owen rolls him over. There's two. It's
Come
over.
On.
Owen and the Bulldog have defeated Goldust and Dude Love. Give the assist to Brian Pillman.
2 weeks in a row. Keep Pillman away from her. 2 weeks in a row. Pillman cost Goldust a win here on Shotgun.
Don't forget Raw this week. It's Vader against Bret Hart. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole. Thanks for joining us this weekend on Shotgun. Shotgun, Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly, Ground Zero, D-Day, next Sunday. And what a broadcast we have for you this week. Bret Hart versus Vader for the WWF title. Goldust will meet Sal Sincere. We'll hear from Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker. All those matches courtesy of Raw as we get ready for tag team action with Flash Funk and Double J, Jesse James.
You missed Pimp Daddy Fink there with the hat on.
Oh, he liked that hat, didn't he? Wearing the Funk Daddy hat.
Well, you know, keep the glare down. Anything will help.
And here they come from Bitters, Arkansas. Henry and Phineas, the Godwins, and they'll be at Ground Zero participating in a fatal four-way matchup for the WWF Tag Team Championship. The Godwins, LOD, Owen Hart, the British Bulldog, and as far as we know, the champions Dude Love and Stone Cold Steve Austin will be involved in this unique matchup.
Well, I don't know if the officials of the World Wrestling Federation really want to have Stone Cold in there defending the tag team titles with Dude Love. Think about it, Michael Cole. Without a doubt, Stone Cold Steve Austin, one of the biggest phenomenons, one of the biggest moneymakers the World Wrestling Federation has ever seen. Do they want their highest priced commodity right now, Stone Cold Steve Austin, getting in the ring and risking permanent injury? I know that is rolling around in the minds of Gorilla Monsoon, Sergeant Slaughter, and a lot of the suits upstairs in Titan Tower.
WWF officials will make a decision, and by this time next week, we will know whether or not Stone Cold will be involved in that matchup at Ground Zero. Of course, he's still suffering from a degenerated disc in his neck, plus his spinal cord is seriously irritated from the pile driver he sustained at SummerSlam at the hands of Owen Hart now, as Henry Godwin locks up with Flash Funk. And Stone Cold still reeling from that spinal injury. I understand, Kevin Kelly, you had the opportunity to talk to Austin this week.
We certainly did, and Stone Cold Steve Austin said he plans on being there Sunday, September 7th, folks. Whether he's able to compete or not, it's not his choice. He's ready to go.
Oh.
But like we said, it's up to the officials of the World Wrestling Federation.
Flash Funk with a nice series of moves. Henry Godwin high-tying it out of the ring now.
Let me ask you this, Kevin. Assuming that Dude Love and Stone Cold Steve Austin would be involved in that fatal four-way matchup, well, who do you give the edge to?
Well, I definitely don't give the edge to the champions. Not only are they facing three other teams, as we take a look at the double feature, the agility of Flash Funk nails the dropkick and Henry Godwin goes scurrying outside. But as I was saying, Michael, not only are there three other teams looking to take the titles, as you see Flash there with the great drop toehold on Phineas Godwin, but also Stone Cold's going to be less than 100% regardless of what the officials say. So I definitely look for new tag team champions to be crowned next Sunday at Ground Zero. That's just my opinion.
Flash Funk now trying to come back. Look at this.
Whoa.
Showing some strength, lifting Phineas high in the air. Big drop kick. Phineas in all kinds of trouble. Nice arm drag takedown by Flash.
Great physical ability. Moves with the power, then to the drop kick. Usually you'll see one or the other. Flash bringing both to the squared circle.
And here comes Double J, Jesse James, working on Phineas Godwin. Nice takedown. Jesse James with a quick cover now of Phineas. There's one before Phineas gets that shoulder up. Double J, of course, from the famous Armstrong wrestling family. His father, the legendary Bullet Bob Armstrong. Now with that front face lock on Phineas Godwin. Double J and Flash Funk really working well as a team here this week here on Shotgun. Double J still with the front face lock on Phineas, but Phineas now turning it around using that strength to back Double J into the corner. Here's a possible double team now by the Godwins. Flash Funk into the ring. What's going to happen in this matchup? We'll see when Shotgun continues. Shotgun Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly, the Godwins now in control of Double J, Jesse James.
Enjoying a little slobber knocker here.
Man, unbelievable. Look at that big elbow by Phineas, and Double J in trouble. He really needs to make a tag to Flash Funk here. About the first time ever, The Undertaker against Shawn Michaels.
That's the one that everybody is talking about. And after what Shawn Michaels did a couple of weeks ago on Raw, like The Undertaker says, there's going to be hell to pay at Ground Zero. But Michael, I got a little report later on. I'll give you some folks some information about who exactly is footing the bill for ravishing Rick Rude. Is it Shawn Michaels? Maybe it's not. We'll talk more about that later on as you take a look. Henry Godwin now really beginning to exert the power on Double J, Jesse James.
Here comes Phineas Godwin. The Godwins really look like they're in shape. They're ready to go. Getting all ready for the fatal four-way matchup, a unique matchup. Kevin, tell us a little bit about a fatal four-way.
Basically, it's four-team elimination tag rules. Any man of any team can be tagged in at any time. So at one point, Michael, you could see Phineas battle Henry Godwin or Owen Hart battle the British Bulldog. The match continues until there is one team left, and it will really be survival of the fittest in the fatal four-way.
Double clothesline now. Phineas and Double J knocking each other down. Now it's a battle to see who can get to their partner first. Both men really need to make a tag here. Double J hoping to get the Flash Funk. We could see some fireworks if that happens. Here comes Henry Godwin. Jesse James gets the Flash, and here comes Funk. Henry misses with a big right hand. Flash Funk with the boot to the midsection. Now he goes to work on Henry Godwin. Whips him into the ropes now. Off the ropes. Ooh, spinning heel kick. This could be it. Covers up the big man from Bitters, Arkansas. Oh, now all four men in the ring. Double J saving Phineas from hitting Flash Funk, but may have cost his partner a pin.
Referee Tim White now decided to pay more attention to Double J than count the lateral press.
Phineas on the apron. He looks like he's up to no good. It's Flash Funk now. Nice reversal by Henry Godwin. Oh, Phineas interfering in the matchup. Flash Funk's in trouble. Henry Godwin setting up Funk now for the slot drop. This could be it. It's over. Nobody gets up from the slot drop. There's one, two, and three. The Godwins victorious over Flash Funk and Jesse James here on Shotgun. Henry and Phineas a tune-up for Ground Zero just around the corner. They're involved in that fatal four-way with Stone Cold Steve Austin and Dude Love, Owen Hart, the British Bulldog, and, of course, the Legion of Doom. Right now, it's time to go to Todd Pettengill. He has this WWF update. Take it away, Todd.
It's the Toddster back with you, reminding you about Ground Zero in your house from the WWF here in the UK. You guys can see all the action September the 7th live at midnight on Sky Sports 1. And don't forget, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels makes a rare public appearance this Monday, September the 1st at 1:30 p.m. at Victoria Square in Birmingham City Center. And he's got a special message for all of his fans here in the UK. The public is invited to attend and hear from the HBK. Now let's talk a little bit about one night only from the World Wrestling Federation from the NEC in Birmingham, September the 20th. I told you guys the place was sold out, but you can see all the action for the very first time via pay-per-view, exclusively live on Sky Box Office at 8 p.m. It is the very first time the WWF will be on pay-per-view here in the UK. Now, you already know the WWF title and European title will be on the line. Now let's run down the rest of the card for you. The world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, will face off against Owen Hart. What's going to happen in this matchup? The world's most dangerous man? Well, Owen Hart always seems to have a plan. We'll find out. You'll also see the Legion of Doom square off against the nasty hog farmers, Henry and Phineas. The Summer of Love will officially come to a close as Dude Love, mankind's alter ego, squares off against Hunter Hearst Helmsley, and it won't be the first time that these two WWF superstars have crossed paths. You will see the Patriot step into the ring with the man they call Vader. Del Wilkes, the Patriot, stands for truth, justice, and the American way, and Vader, well, he pretty much stands anywhere he wants to. You will also see the Headbangers taking on Savio Vega and Miguel from Los Periques. You will see newcomer Tiger Ali Singh locking up with Leif Cassidy. Plus, there are rumors that there may be a WWF free-for-all before the event officially begins in Birmingham. I'm hearing talk of a match between Flash Funk and Rockabilly. As soon as we have that word, we'll get...
Welcome back to Shotgun. Michael Cole along with Kevin Kelly. Thanks for joining us this week. And, of course, we're pointing all our sights toward Sunday, September 7th, next Sunday, round zero. And here he comes now, a rookie here in the World Wrestling Federation. There he is, Tiger Ali Singh, flanked by his father. To his right, the legendary Tiger Jeet Singh and also the Iron Sheik.
Tiger Ali Singh, no rookie as far as experience in his corner. Over five decades of competitive experience leading Tiger Ali Singh to what they feel will be the golden path to the World Wrestling Federation title. Tiger Ali Singh very hopeful of following in the footsteps of one of his idols of his career, fellow Canadian Bret the Hitman Hart. And I got a feeling that Tiger Jeet Singh, I know his dad with the microphone, would love to see his son become champion.
What's he saying?
What was that all about? Didn't the Beatles get in trouble for playing stuff backwards on a record once?
Now I know you can understand the Iron Sheik.
You're Muhammad, you're Ali, and you shut up and don't say USA.
You shut up and don't say USA.
I'm flabbergasted that you even understood that much, Michael.
Are we gonna hear from Tiger?
Now him I understand. He speaks perfect English. He speaks many languages, as a matter of fact.
And he is a great athlete. Really came into the World Wrestling Federation on fire when he won the Kuwaiti Cup tournament earlier this spring. And so far here in the WWF, he's undefeated.
Certainly is. And a lot of men in the locker room really beginning to notice Tiger Ali Singh's progression. And you take a look with Tiger Jeet Singh and the Iron Sheik in his corner. That is a wealth of experience and
big boot to the midsection.
Tiger Ali Singh now whipping Adam O'Brien across the ring. Ooh, big forearm across the chest. And Tiger Ali Singh is in control now of this matchup. Nice suplex. O'Brien in all kinds of trouble. Tiger Ali Singh, Indo-Canadian from Toronto, Canada, working now on Adam O'Brien.
Fans, we need to tell you the UK Superstar line is up and running. 0891-299-888. The maximum cost of the call, £3. Calls cost 50p a minute, regardless of the time of the call. If you're under 18 years of age, parental permission is required before calling. And fans, Shawn Michaels will be at Victoria Square in Birmingham City Center on Monday, September 1st. That's this Monday at 1:30 p.m. It's open to the public, and Shawn will have a special message for all UK fans. And look at Tiger now. What an outstanding athlete, Kevin.
He was one of the greatest high school basketball players in Canada. And if you're recruited to Notre Dame, that says two things. Number one, you're a great athlete. Number two, you're very intelligent. And Tiger Ali Singh, when you hear him, it's a little bit controversial in his views, but he definitely is a very intelligent man and very, very physically gifted as well.
Adam O'Brien in all kinds of trouble, back down against the knee that time. Tiger Ali Singh now going up to the ropes. He likes to work off the top ropes. Very agile for a big man.
Well, he's going up. He's going to want to finish things here, I think, Michael.
Tiger Ali Singh now on the top ropes. Adam O'Brien in trouble. Oh, a bulldog off the top rope. That should do it. Tiger Ali Singh covering up O'Brien. Here it is now. 2 and 3. It's all over. The rookie, Tiger Ali Singh, victorious on Shotgun.
This man is being groomed for greatness. Father Tiger Jeet Singh. Now, that's something that we do not need.
Oh, no. Come on.
Commissioner Slaughter, I'm sure, will have a conversation with the Singhs later on. We don't need the Sheik, nor do we need Tiger Jeet involved in any physical action.
Come on now. Adam O'Brien was outmatched the entire matchup, and Tiger Ali Singh rubbing salt in the wounds, tossing him over the top ropes.
Is there any chance of being able to hear from Tiger Jeet Singh or possibly the Iron Sheik again?
I'd like another chance at translation.
I want to understand. Oh, no, look out. Oh, now he's giving it to Tiger. I guess
now
we are going to hear from Tiger.
I understand.
Cut the music!
This might not be any more intelligent than his father in the Iron Sheik, though. Listen to the reaction for Tiger Ali Singh from Toronto, Canada, from this American crowd.
I want you all to give me the respect that I deserve as being a proud Canadian.
He's not going to get it that way.
Say Canada, that's the magic word to hear booze.
You showed your ignorance, you have no class, and you're showing the people around the world, my beautiful country people, my beautiful fans in Canada, and my beautiful fans all over the world, that you Americans have no class.
You wouldn't know it by the reaction here, but Tiger Ali Singh is loved worldwide. So is his father.
Listen to this crowd, though. Tiger Ali Singh not endearing himself to this American crowd this week on Shut. Sunday, ground zero, the Patriot against Brett, the WWF Championship on the line. It all happens live at midnight, September 7th on Sky Sports 1. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Have a great week.